In the chat, please
mark them down, mark them up, mark them around.
Up,
what is the deal, y'all? It's Monday night. We got a lot of friends in the chat right here joining us on the Monday rendition of the Mystery School stream, man. We may or may not be hitting that front page a little bit later on in the stream today. We'll let you know if we get scared enough to tell you. Also, we got a guaranteed sudden death coming in for that ass tonight, man. Got it unlocked for you, so get ready for a live song from scratch under 30 minutes.
And, dude, speaking of, I spent like about an hour before the stream just finding brand new sudden death samples. So we got a pretty nice assortment of samples for tonight's sudden death, some brand new shit.
That's right. We got them locked in, man. So get ready for sudden death coming up a bit later, man. But for now, enjoy this DJ mix. Write us some letters from the class as well if you can. We got the letters from the class section in the Discord right here for you. Go ahead and hit that up. Write us some shit, man. We've been having some great questions lately. We need some more, though, because it's Monday and all the other shit is old now. So
oh, dude. Also, regarding the hot chip, I know it's a hot button issue, no pun intended. The Amazon order didn't come yet. I ordered it on Amazon. It's not here yet. The hot chip is coming, I promise. But we can't eat it tonight.
Hot chip imminent, man. Don't worry about that, y'all. Hot chip is on the way, man. But just out of just sheer spite for the hot chip not being here, join the Discord and curse at us in there because we don't have the chip. That'd be pretty fun, right?
Yeah.
Get your anger out. Post a meme in there and, you know, spread misinformation if you feel like it. It's Mystery School Discord.
We love disinformation in the Mystery School Discord. It's our favorite. All Omar Bones do is make hot beat, not eat hot chip, and lie.
eat hot meat, not make hot chip. Eat hot meat, not
Dan Keefe says, eat something else for us on stream, Owen. We need it. Any suggestions?
Need some just food, huh? Just throw out a handful of just fresh mayonnaise, man. Just in the palm of your hand, and you just gulp it down right before sudden death starts, man. That's pretty fun.
No cap.
No cap.
None.
No cap. I don't wear cap. Because we like no cap.
It's the footwork mix.
No cap.
For a little bit.
No cap.
I'm from Pennsylvania, and this is no cap.
No cap.
Oh, Wu-Tang Dan brought up something that we'll talk about in a little bit. Tony, do you have any thoughts on Kingdom Hearts 4? Actually, we do. We'll talk about that in a little bit when we get into that news, man. We got a Kingdom Hearts 4 update for you, along with some other shit, man. Somebody found a small mayo door leading to the mayo dimension in New York somewhere. We'll talk about that in a little bit. What else is going on out here? Deep fakes, they're back again, doing shit, impersonating your favorite celebrities. Getting them in trouble. We'll talk about all that and more in the stream news coming up in a little bit, man. Keep posting that shit.
Yes. No Pabst. No Pabst is most way.
No PBR?
Damn. No Pabst. We got guaranteed sudden death coming up tonight. We got news coming up. We got letters from the class coming up. And we have a new feature here on the stream to heckle front page viewers.
Oh, yeah. What y'all think about this, man?
When they show up, we're going to pull this up, and then they'll all come into the stream and be our friends.
We got plans, man. So we're about to heckle the front page people by posting up big-ass rainbow signs like that one. Hopefully, it attract a bunch of randos to come in here and yell at us. That'll happen later on when we hit the front page, possibly. Stay tuned for that, man.
Enjoy some of this DJ mix.
Yes.
Yes, we're going to scream at them. Real Gamer 261 with 5 gifted subs. Dude, Real Gamer, thank you so much, man. Yo, how was your date? You said you were going on a double date, right?
Yeah, how'd you do, Real Gamer? Let us know if it was a pass or a fail. I hope you won, man. Don't you disappoint me tonight. Real easy to disappoint.
Real Gamer.
Cover.
Thank you. I got a good feeling about the stream tonight. We got a bunch of brand new sudden death samples. We got a banger selection of news tonight. Letters from the class pouring in as we speak.
Oh, is it? Let me see. We got some new entries. Oh yeah, we do. A couple of them. So keep dropping those letters from the class in the stream news. I mean, in the letters from the class section of the Discord. We need those, man. Ask for some advice. Our friend Real Gamer asked us for some advice about his double date that he had this weekend.
Yeah.
And hopefully we gave him some solid advice that led him to the land of sex, you know, or at least a good beginning of a friendship, platonically.
Yeah,
this person that he went on
a date. Yeah, maybe, you know, just a nice handhold or a thigh touch.
Just some stern eye contact, you know, that'll get the motor revving too if you try hard enough. So drop us a letter from the class. We always here to give you advice and help you out when you try to date and you fail.
Yes.
Come on back to mystery school and let us help you out. We'll get you out of that jam.
Dumb Ops says, I took a pic of Bun B without his consent at a Meg show in the age in 2019. He wasn't happy.
Hey, what the fuck hey. Going on? That ain't true.
Yeah,
what's up,
everybody? Bun B, a great guy, man. I wish we could get him on the stream one day.
Bun B, come on the stream.
Come on the stream.
Bun B, up here.
I wonder what he would do on the Mystery School stream. He's like, man.
Man, Mikey, y'all tripping out over here, man.
Damn.
What the fuck you got going on, man?
Big Lou says, we live in a bust-the-nut nation.
Bust it. Bust it.
Salute.
That's right, y'all. Letters from the class coming up in about another 9 minutes. You still got some time. Write us something. Oh, is the footwork coming up? It's almost that time, huh? I'm hitting that shit, but you can't.
He's hitting it.
You can't see my feet, but they're going fast as fuck.
Oh,
turn that shit up. Let's go, y'all.
Lady Sen, welcome back for 15 months. Thank you.
Hope y'all had a good weekend.
Thank you.
Let us know how your weekend was, man. What'd you do? What'd you get into? What'd you get out of? Prison? a relationship, let us know in the chat. I want to see how your weekend was. Let's fucking go.
If you got out of prison or a relationship, let us know. Let me know. I'm bursting, says Lake.
This song is so great.
I didn't realize until I was listening to this in the shower that this is a diss track. Like, yeah. I thought it was just abstractly he was saying y'all, generally, DJ House Party.
This ain't endearing, man. This is a diss.
Yeah, this is
he's a shitting
diss.
On somebody for being a pedestrian-ass DJ.
Yeah.
DJing house parties, man. It's hardcore, bro. You never want anybody to accuse you of DJing house parties, man.
I like or DJ house parties.
Or Ralph parties. y'all DJ Mouse parties as well in the chat. Thank you for that.
One of the few DJs keeping footwork alive on Twitch.
It's a hard job, but somebody's got to do it, man. Fucking right, man. Good old school sudden death topic right here, y'all DJ house parties. It's amazing. I wonder what tonight's sudden death will be, man. Anybody got any ideas? What y'all thinking, man? What's going to happen? Pentacle Meow, thank you for that sub, too. I saw that.
Pentacle Meow.
Thank you for the resub.
Appreciate that.
Wow, it's almost time for new recorded music.
Yes. Get back in the studio soon as shit, man. It's almost goddamn time.
Don't mind me. Just fixing the green screen.
White and yellow Air Max as I step out my leg.
We got a couple more songs left. Weird ways to intimidate your fellow man. Sudden death suggests Jerry Cho.
That could happen. See what's going on.
Yo, Chef,
Dr. Reed, thank you for that sub too.
In two words, how was your weekend this weekend? Let me know.
Yes.
Two words maximum.
You got gifted a sub, thank you, gifter. I got a Rolex collection. Mystery School stream live on a Monday, man. I want to see that sub train going off today, man. Can we hit the hype train? What the hell are we going to do, man? We got sudden death coming up, so we'll have to do something, man. Wow, we got some weekend descriptions in the chat. Weekend was too short, says Kicks of Flair. DJ Jazzy Jules was high this weekend.
He was high?
Jerry Cho said, poop shitty, to be honest.
Poop shitty. I'm sorry.
My guy said, I left the job. Okay, I guess that means he quit.
Just fine, says Slash Just Out. That's good to hear, honestly.
Said he first says, sleepy pee. I like sleepy pee.
Yeah, that's
you wake
cozy.
Up out of your sleep and go pee, and you know it's all dark and warm in the bathroom, and you still got your eyes halfway closed, and you just try to hit the toilet and make sure you don't pee on the wall. It's cozy.
Hard work. Meatball dinner. Sweet thing, Dan.
Cozy, cozy. Oh, some new letters from the class just came in. We got a grip now. A fat ass grip of letters from the class, man. If you didn't write one, you still got some time. Got another 4 minutes. Pushing piss.
Pushing piss. What's the gamble?
Pushing piss.
How full can we get the pot before letters from the class ends? Over 500,000 points and under 500,000 points are the options? Ooh,
it's
that's a chaos gamble.
Degenerate gambling. Okay. Oh, well, I mean, it looks like there's a precedent, man. Maybe I can get in and sway it with a bunch of channel points real quick.
Yeah, can we
make
an
upset happen?
The Nash attack with the gifted sub. Thank you very much. Appreciate that.
Let's go, Nash.
We got time for another song or two here. Hit some letters from the class if you would not mind. Write in. We'll answer your questions, comments, or concerns here on the Mystery School stream. We got letters from the class coming up, then the news, then guaranteed sudden death tonight. A full song from scratch in under 30 minutes with our friends from the front page. And the Nash attack hitting us with another gifted sub. Thank you.
Let's go. Nash attack unlocking sudden death for years to come, man. This will unlock another sudden death for another day. We appreciate you. Fucking get it?
I wonder if we go on the front page just yet. No, we go on a 10.
No. Okay, yeah, we got some time.
Bob Egg says, I was drunk on Friday, so I am sorry, and I would like to formally apologize. What I've done Friday has been against the rules. I'm sorry for the things I've said, though I do believe that what I typed in the chat here this Friday has been informative and important. Bob Egg, we forgive you.
Listen, I am thankful and I respect you, Mystery School, for this opportunity. And I apologize. And it cut off right there. Thank you, Bob Eggs, kicking it off like a real master right there. Lame James taking a page out of the Bob Eggs book and copy pasting that. You guys are really, you guys are impressive tonight. Yes. That's a nice sound right there.
A couple songs left.
For the class. Coming up. Write us some shit, man. I'm trying to help you not live a terrible life. Please let me help you.
Let us help you.
Let me. I got to think of a prompt for tonight's Let Us In Your House, too, man. Last stream. What did we do? We did something that you thought would impress us.
I did like
that. We had you all bring a sacrifice to the Mystery School altar to present to us to see if we would accept.
Maybe it's something we would hate today?
Yeah. Tonight's Let Us In Your House prompt is let us see something you think we would hate.
Specifically us. Not just like people in general. Specifically
just
we would hate.
Us, personally. I, Tony Reed Jr., and Owen Bones would specifically hate. We would not like this thing. So go ahead and post those in the Discord. We'll take a look at them in the Let Us In Your House segment a little bit later.
We will take a look. I'm about to lurk on Discord. Yo, also, shout out to GOAK, who came into the Discord last night and said, man, I'm so high that I'm watching the VOD right now. And he came in to post Let Us In Your House content while watching the VOD.
Nice. If you ever been that high in your goddamn life, let us know in the chat with a number one, man. You've been high enough to repost Mystery School YouTube VODs. You going to the Discord acting like we're still here? Press 1 in the chat.
Yeah.
Up 0 QQ.
Also, I think we missed a resub from Brittany Beauty for 13 months. Brittany Beauty.
Well, let's go, Brittany.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
It be like that sometimes.
Yeah. Y'all getting so high that y'all posting on dead streams that ain't even alive that day?
Nice.
Should have just squatted in the chat.
What is this fucking copy pasta?
Oh, Rich Rikishi. Oh, well, yeah.
Who is that?
Oh, the wrestler, the dude that used to rub his ass on you as his special move.
Oh,
he was a huge Hawaiian guy. But they're imagining him with a vagina.
Markov says, Ari Flux snapped, I fear. Type 1 in the chat if you are concerned about the mental well-being of one of your fellow Mystery School viewers.
That copypasta made me pucker my lips a little bit in a sour face.
That copypasta gave me an egg smell in this room.
Dirk Noontime.
Dirk.
Appreciate you, Dirk.
Welcome back.
It'd be easy for him to squirt. Oh, God. Yeah, that copypasta made me not like certain smells and foods right now.
Jaguar Germ says, how many gifted subs for Owen and Tony to 1v1 in a chess match? I'm pretty mediocre at chess. Are you decent at chess?
No, I'm not that great. I don't have like a strategy. I just kind of go all out. I know the rules of chess and I know what pieces move where, but I don't have a really good strategy. So
yeah,
I'm not that great. But I mean, maybe that's what'll make it amazing. You know, maybe that's what'll make it a good match.
Yeah. I don't know, Jaguar Germ, man. I don't know if that's the content our viewers want to see, but we can work something out. Maybe we play chess during sudden death. We have to complete a game of chess during sudden death.
Yeah, just rushed moves and
PvP sudden death.
Just doing all kind of chaotic moves on the chessboard and just completely fucking the game up. Yeah, I like the idea. We'll set that at 665. 60. Wait, no, that's not enough. 70. 70 subs, and we play a digital chess game during sudden death.
Yes.
We can't promise the moves will be great. We gotta rush through it and just click whatever the fuck and just try to make it through the game while we're doing sudden death. So hey,
Bureau's Elliot says, how much to see him duel in regular old-fashioned ritual combat? 100 subs.
65 subs.
Yeah, that's 65.
For a little shootout in the middle of the street.
They're gonna legalize dueling any day now.
I think Will Smith already kicked it off, man.
Yeah, that's true.
The public slap in the face. That was a dual starter.
Yo, the hot chip, I ordered it on Amazon. It didn't show up in time today, guys. I'm sorry about that. I thought it would be here. I promise the chip is on the way. The chip is on the way.
No, we don't eat hot chip and lie.
We eat hot chip.
We get hot chip and tell the truth.
Jazzy
DJ
Jules.
Jazzy Jules.
Welcome back. Continuing that sub.
Sexy new sub right there. And
Proper Poe Man for 39
thing.
Months.
Let's fucking go, bro.
Proper Poe Man, thank you so much for your support, dude.
General right there. Noah Reigns doing it too. Oh, they're trying to get us to duel in the street. Oh, y'all trying to get us to have an old-fashioned Western shootout in the middle of a Chicago alley.
Uh-oh. Proper Poe Man is nearly 40 in the chat right now.
Tango said, y'all worship him. We will worship. Anybody who's been here for 39 months, we worship you.
Yeah. Also, it's looking like the people who bet over 500K points in the pot are fucked right now.
Yeah, you guys didn't even come halfway close.
Looking pretty bad.
That was a drunk-ass gamble if you bet over 500K points. You didn't think about
it. Whoever put points in that is about to be down so terrible. Also, there's a very chaotic gamble going right now, not state-sanctioned in any way. We didn't have any role in this, just drawing attention to it.
Wow. Ray J with the genius 4D chess move. If he, as a whale with millions of channel points, decides to just dump 200 to 300K in there, he could just completely take that pot right now.
Damn.
Based on you guys not being active. So
wow, well,
damn, well played, Ray J. You could just split it with me if you get if you get the lion's share. Let me get a piece of that pot.
Ray J can do some insider trading right now. That's crazy.
I mean, the numbers are right there in his face. He could just add up the math and be like, you know what?
Yeah, he's got a cool M. All right. Anyway, you guys figure it out during the intro to the stream. But for now, computer,
yo,
start the show.
Let's fucking go.
You're watching Mystery School, the first late night show on the net, with your hosts Owen Bones and Tony B. Jr. Let's begin.
Oh, shit.
Wow. He really just undercut the competition and robbed y'all out of your hard-earned channel points. You lost.
Damn.
Oh, my God. He snuck up and kicked everybody's ass. It's almost 700,000 channel points in option number one right now.
Holy
shit. That shit changed quick. Life comes at you fast, guys.
I lost all my money, says Charlie Torque in all caps. Tom.
Damn, you thought it was a surefire bet. You're like, oh, we won't get over 500K.
Wait, Ray J says, bet. I didn't put shit in LMAO.
Oh, we got another
whale. It was another
whale. Damn.
Oh, shit.
Wow. Well, I guess that bet is over with. Over 500K channel points.
Wow.
You chose. I bet people started like betting towards that once they saw that it started to skyrocket. They're like, oh shit, let me put in some more money on this so I don't lose all my cash.
I put 200 goddamn points in that, this real gamer.
As soon as it put, Kango did it.
Yeah.
As soon as it hit 500K, I threw in another 10K.
I blame Owen. Hey, yo, dude, I just draw some attention to the gamble, man. That's what we're all here for. You can't blame me.
Yeah,
I didn't know.
It's just gambling.
I didn't know insider trading would ruin this. Whoever did it, step forward, though. Let us know.
Wow. Only 37 people are splitting almost a million channel points, dude. There's 866,000 channel points that only 37 people got to split.
Damn.
Where else can you come up like that besides the Mystery School stream, man?
Yep, that's what we're talking about here.
Damn.
That's what we're talking about. Welcome to the Mystery School stream on a Monday. Can we please have some question marks or union emotes in the chat? It's going to be a good Monday today, everyone. I got that feeling. I have that tingle in the back of my spine. We're going to be on the front page at 10 o'clock in half an hour from right now. We're testing out some experimental new fan conversion technology here on the Mystery School stream. Sure to bring plenty of new friends into the show using this hot new technique.
Yeah, basically, it'll yell at the people on the front page that see us in the middle carousel. And hopefully they look at it and get intrigued enough to come in here and see what the fuck they're being summoned here for.
Yeah. So they'll click in and be like, whoa, this is tight. And then that's how we win.
Yeah. Through deception, basically. Yes.
Pretty
much. That's what we're going to do.
Pretty much. So we're hitting the front page in 29 minutes from this moment in time right now. If you're new to the stream, that means we will be suddenly broadcast to everyone on the homepage of Twitch And sometimes we get literally tens of thousands of new viewers in an instant. Or we may just be on the back or side page today and not that many new people show up. But we'll see, man. We'll see how it goes.
It's a win-win either way because we get to launch our new message and harass somebody that didn't even know we existed. So
absolutely.
It's a win-win.
All right. Well, we got news coming up. We got a guaranteed sudden death going down tonight. We are making a full song live from scratch in under 30 minutes. And you choose the topic based off of all the shit we're covering tonight. And the shit we are covering tonight is spicy, if I do say so myself. After having read hundreds of articles here on the stream, there is a good selection tonight. And I'm looking forward to it. So
yeah.
To start things off, though, we should kick some letters from the class, man. You want to get started here?
Yeah, I got a good one right here. This one is not as much of a joke as the usual questions here because you guys got dumbass questions all the time. But this one is pretty good. It says, are music videos underrated or overrated nowadays?
Okay, I would say music videos were overrated for a while, and now they are underrated, in my personal opinion. I think that a music video now is like almost a grotesque use of money because they don't really generate much for artists anymore. So to deliberately do a music video is like a really cool artistic statement, in my opinion, because I'm like, unless you're a huge artist, you're probably not going to like recoup on the music video.
Never.
It's kind of like a dedicated thing. Like, yo, I just want to show off this cool visual for my song. So in that regard, I think it's underrated because most artists don't have the bandwidth to do it.
Yep, totally agree with that one, man. And I also would like to add that I just don't think it's I don't think that the consumer of today cares about those as much as the past, as much as history would tell you. I think videos are just kind of I guess, like you said, just something cool to do if you're rich enough and could just
you
do
can
a video
it, yeah.
And just put that bitch out. But yeah, I don't think they're as important. They used to be everything,
yeah.
Man. Blog era videos, you had to shoot videos for like everything
right.
You made a song to, basically.
Right.
But nowadays, not so much, man. I don't think you really have to shoot
right.
as many videos. And it would suck to make a really, really, really cool video, and there's not many outlets for videos
for real
nowadays. So it's like, damn, you made a really fucking tight video, but like, not a lot of people get to see
yeah,
it because it's just not, there's no platform just showing videos in that light right now.
Grishmapolitan, also, thank you for the 9-month resub. Good to see you. Appreciate that. Yeah, I think videos are pretty indulgent, honestly. Like, dude, like, music videos cost like $10,000 plus for a good one a lot of the time. And people will look at a 30-second snippet of it on Instagram or Twitter, and like, that's it. You're not even
that's
really
it.
Getting people to click into YouTube to watch the full thing and like comment on it anymore. So
I have not been to YouTube to watch a music video. If it's not on Twitter, going down my timeline, and then I can just click it and get like a minute and a half of it.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna see it, man.
So it's a tough sell.
It's tough right now,
it's
man.
It's a tough sell.
I make music and I don't even watch music videos, dude. Yeah. Like, it's fucked up.
So I would say music videos are underrated for that reason, that they're really cool creative expression, but it's kind of hard to do them and to get people to see them. So anyway.
Yeah. All right.
All right. Total opposite of that question here. Okay, hear me out. This is from Laker Fan. Would y'all eat 6 ounces of the stuff that accumulates in the corner of random people's mouths, parentheses, guaranteed you won't die or get sick, for $2 billion USD? Yes, absolutely. If you can guarantee that I will not get sick, suffer any sort of ailment, or receive transmissible disease
from eating the mouth chud,
yes, I would do it.
$2 billion,
yes.
You don't even got to promise me that I won't get sick. I'll still do it, you know, and roll the dice because, man, it's $2 billion, man.
Yeah.
Fuck it, dude. I'll try it, man, and hopefully, you know, my immune system is strong enough to.
Yeah.
Outlast the mouth chust.
Grishmapolitan says, I could plug my nose into it. Exactly. You know, just do it in one shovel. And then you got two bees richer, you know? Can I put hot sauce on it? Yeah, I think so. Can I add lemon? Yeah, you can season it or flavor it. Yeah. People are saying nah in the chat for $2 billion.
You're done. You don't got to do anything anymore. With $2 billion, it's cool. You can relax. Capitalism's over at that point,
right,
man.
Right, it's
so
fine.
I'm taking that risk, man.
Well, 6 ounces is a lot, but I'll force myself, dude.
Yeah, and I could just throw it up, right? Like, after I'm done, I could just and exercise it out of my body.
If you're allowed to throw up, yeah, for sure.
Wow. Well, interesting nonetheless there, but $2 billion, a lot of money, man. I might have to eat some Would you eat dog poop for $2 million, guys? How about that?
If you could guarantee that I wouldn't get sick or get die, I would eat a lot of things for $2 billion.
Just scarfing down some little turds, man, just for $6 billion or $2 billion, I'm sorry. Wow. Well, Mystery School hosts are indeed whores for $2 billion. We'll do whatever you ask. Yes. As long as you can promise we won't die, we'll do it.
Meet America's newest billionaire, says Anthony in the chat.
He ate mouth chest.
All right, you got a more question here?
Yeah, I got one right here. This one is pretty interesting as well. It says, what's one off-brand or generic brand item that is better than the name brand?
Oh, God. Do you have one off top?
Off top? Shit. Off top.
Chat, help us out.
Off-brand or
cereal? Paper towels.
Cereal's usually bad. Off-brand cereal, not to clash.
I wouldn't say
usually not.
I can't think of any off-brand stuff that's better. I can think of stuff that's serviceable and cheaper, like toilet paper, for instance. You don't always need to go for the Charmin, but sometimes you run the risk of wiping your ass and you finger yourself a little bit, but
split a vein or a blood vessel in your asshole from your sharp fingernail. That can happen too, man. Honestly, this is gonna be broad, but in my fucked up opinion in world, clothes, man. Oh. Like, I like bootleg shit, man.
Yeah,
like this
sure.
ain't really Bart Simpson. Like, this is some bootleg shit. Like, it's not Bart and Homer for real. Like, he's black as shit. Like, he's doing the Haitian Revolution. Like, this is not something that is a real item here. It's bootleg. So I would say clothing, man, in a lot of different ways. I like bootleg clothes, man. That shit's pretty fun.
Ferg Methazine says, fucked up in the crib eating cream betweens.
Fucked up in the crib eating fruity rounds.
Some purple stuff says, off-brand auto parts work pretty well.
Off-brand auto parts, that's pretty good. Mm. Off-brand dishes and utensils, like, I think those are pretty good.
Sometimes you can get an off-brand game controller, sometimes being the keyword.
I don't know about that.
Usually not, but sometimes. Private label condoms?
Pets? You guys ever had, like, off-brand pet? Like, it's not exactly a pit bull, like they said, but it's mixed with some pit bull, it's not a purebred cat.
It's a dog.
It's mixed with some raccoon, but it's still kind of a cat, so. Yeah. Yeah, off-brand pets are cool too, man.
All right, let's keep it going here. I'm leafing through. Oh shit, some of these are actually crazy. Anonymous asks, should I cop the Yeezy Stem Player? Seems like a legit cool piece of hardware. If you like Kanye and want to directly support Kanye West, yeah, go for it. Otherwise, probably not. It is a cool piece of technology, but it's not like you can use it for other music, can you? Isn't it like just Kanye's music?
No, Stem Player, you can USB that thing, and I think you can put other shit on there.
Oh, if you care enough to find stems of other music, then yeah, but I don't know, man. Isn't that shit like $100 or something?
$200?
Yeah,
I think so.
Oh, God.
I would like to see... I would like to see that idea fleshed out some more, too, because I think it's a cool idea. And I do like that it is an analog, tactile thing that you can, like, touch and hold. It's not just another plug-in on Ableton or some shit, man. So that's cool. I want them to flesh it out some more and allow me to, like, put a song in there, like, just a regular MP3, and then let the stem player, like, create the stem.
That'd be cool.
And, like, break it down. Because there are plugins on, like, Ableton and Pro Tools and shit that can just take an MP3 and they can just separate the vocals, the drums.
There's websites that do that now for free.
Yeah. So if the stem player could start doing some shit like that, I'd be into that.
Yeah. I would say currently, though, for me, definitely not worth it. Don't care nearly enough about Kanye. And the other applications are, like, you can do with other things. So... you love Kanye West history, probably. If not, I don't know, man. $200 is a lot of money.
I do not love Kanye West to give him. I don't know if I want to give him any money for anything, honestly. Like, I think he's rich enough, and I'm not the demographic of the fan that he's going for, so we don't really need to cross paths.
You want to do one or two more here and then get into the news?
Yeah, let's get this one right here. One of our Anon buddies has asked us, if you're both influencers, what influences would you influence on everyone if you were both influencers?
In a perfect world, I don't know, man. This kind of a kind of a,
it's a real meta conversation.
Bit of a PBS after school special answer here, but like reasonability, I would say, like the ability to not freak out on others and listen to what many people have to say and form an opinion. I think that would probably be what I'd like to influence, you know?
Influence. What would I like to influence?
Give us a real devious answer to counterbalance my...
Just counterbalance some fucked up shit. I'm influencing pure chaos. Yeah. Nah, I would like to influence... I'd like to influence not being a fucking hater, honestly.
Liking things?
Yeah,
influence like... people to genuinely support things?
Liking things and not fucking like just... hating on shit on the internet and just getting online and just seeing things and just hating on them, because that's the thing about the internet that is the biggest like turn off to me, man. It's just like everybody's just so anonymously mean and just like want to talk shit about everything, and especially when people are doing like artistic things.
Yeah.
And it's already hard enough to put yourself out there like that with some art. True or some that. creative, and then just the sentiment of like the internet in general is just like, it's funny to just go hate on some shit, right, and crush that person's dreams and crush their fucking morality. But I don't think that's that cool, man. I think that's the one really lame thing about the internet. It just empowers people to do shit that they wouldn't do, right, in person. Yeah. Like, you wouldn't come up to a person outside in the real world and go up to them like, yo, I fucking, your shit sucks, yeah, dude. I don't like this painting, because you'd have to deal with that real life interaction. But the cowardice of the internet, where you can just hide behind the screen and just talk shit, is what I would like to change, man.
Definitely.
So
I agree.
I would try to influence that, man. Yeah. Just don't. Why hate? Like, you can do what you want to do, right, without hating on this other person. It's not hurting you.
Yeah. Well, two pretty wholesome answers there. I'm pleased with those. All right, last question here. Taylor Jane the Great asks, I recently bought DJ equipment and I'm really excited to start. I've always had an interest in DJing, but I'm completely fresh to it. So my question is for Owen, do you have any tips or advice for a freshie like me? Taylor Jane the Great, I definitely do. I think people look at producing, DJing to a lesser extent, as like a really technical thing that like you need to like understand music or a bunch of technology or whatever. It's very, very, very simple. There are no rules to DJing at all, other than if you want it to sound professional, you just learn how to beat match, which is literally learning to count to four in your head on beat. You go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and you play the new song on the one. And if you can do that, you can already DJ. And beyond that, it's just about figuring out what sort of music you want to play and really getting a feel for, you know, what sort of vibe are you trying to give off when you play music. And once you do it for a while, you just learn your library and can kind of switch between moods and stuff. And there's all sorts of other random weird technical shit like effects and stuff like that, but it's very, very, very simple to learn the DJ. Literally just learn how to count beats and you're off to the races. That's really the best advice that I could give you, I think.
I have no DJ advice. I DJed maybe twice and I wasn't good at it.
But it's like just counting to the one, right? And then you play the new song on the one.
Yeah, I couldn't even manage that though. I fucked that up even. I had Serato and I was on my laptop, and yeah, I was in charge of a DJ set for some fucking reason. I think I just like kind of lied and was like,
I can DJ.
Oh yeah, I could do it, because they were like, we'll give you money. And I was like, oh yeah, I can do it. I'll do a DJ set. And they're like, yeah, thank you. Just do a DJ set. Went up there and just didn't do a great job at all. I had the fire slaps. I put the great songs on. I put a great selection of music on, but I have no sort of theme or order to the songs I play. I have no sort of vibe or like any type of like concept. I'm just like playing
slaps.
Like go from like up West Side Gun, house band, folk black metal band, and then I go into MIA and then play Roddy Ricch,
dude,
and then
honestly,
it's just like, dude, what the fuck are you doing?
Most of the most turnt DJ sets I've ever seen in my life were people who could not mix for shit, would just had like a good ear for the sort of song that would drive people into a frenzy, train wrecked the mix. It sounded terrible, but as soon as that next song came on, everyone forgot. It was fine. You know,
yeah.
So
that's the kind of DJ I was, man. I'm nothing but vibes.
If you
want
a DJ out there, anyone in the chat or Taylor Jane the Great, don't worry too much about the technicality of it. If you can make a transition that sounds pretty good, it doesn't matter how you did it, really. Just pick some good songs that you think people like to hear, and you're good to go. You're good to go.
Yeah.
All right. Well, on that note, we are hitting the front page in 15 minutes. God help us. We're not sure what's going to happen. We could get a shitload of new viewers. We could get a trickle. Either way, we're heckling them with this when it happens. So get ready for that. Meanwhile, we got some news to get into and a guaranteed sudden death coming up in 1 hour and 14 minutes from this moment in time. right now. Y'all ever had anyone try to make a beat live during a set?
Make a beat live?
Like someone that's not us?
Like a fucker just hopped out from
there
the crowd.
There was one
was like,
time.
I'll make a beat.
I remember I was when I was with you guys on tour, something came up where Chuck wanted to freestyle and he was like, yo, Owen, make a beat. And I was like, and it was when I had the drum pad set up. So I just and then I just like played a beat and it was fine. But I was my heart dropped for a second because I was like, what do you mean make a beat, dude? I'm the DJ. But
insanity,
we figured
man.
It out. We figured it out. So, yes, technically, Chuck English told me to make a beat during a live show.
That makes sense that it would come from a chaotic figure like that.
Anyway, let's get into some news. We got plenty of good shit to talk about tonight that is sudden death worthy. So to kick it off, we got to talk about Kingdom Hearts 4, baby. That's right. The characters in Kingdom Hearts wearing big ass shoes and Donald Duck and all that shit are in real life now.
Not anymore. It looked like Sora took off the big goofy boots and started selling NFTs and invested in Tesla and shit, man.
Yeah.
So get ready for a lot of late night parties with Sora and his new friends living in downtown Tokyo.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting, man. They really did remove all of the weird ass big shoe ass shit that made Kingdom Hearts
shoe
Kingdom
ass
Hearts. Because like it was truly Sora wearing these gigantic, all the characters wore gigantic clown shoes, and now they're in real life looking like VTubers. You saw the trailer, right?
Yeah. Do they have that here?
I can pull it up in the background. Hold on.
Yeah, it would be good to just flash that, man. It's a little dysphoric, but goddamn, it looked nice though. Look very visually stunning, man. So I'm sure that'll be on our side.
Yeah. It's Unreal Engine looking shit in real life with some cool graphics, and Sora looks like this now.
Yo, he looked like a model for a very high end brand in Japan.
Yes.
Somewhere.
So he's looking like a humanoid. So is everyone else. They're barefooted and have no clown shoes anymore.
He boop too big for your goddamn feet.
Big creature comes down and they start doing fucking parkour all around, and you know it looks pretty cool.
This shit looks good graphic wise.
I will say, and this will probably upset some of our viewers, I've just never been a fan of Kingdom Hearts, man. I don't dislike it, but especially by the time Kingdom Hearts 3 came out.
Oh no, they lost me after 2.
And like you go into Frozen World and Goofy's like, hey, look, we gotta unlock the secret of darkness. I'm like, man, shut the fuck up, dude. I get that it's cool and kitschy and nostalgic, but it just doesn't do it for me, man.
Yeah, it was just that big gap between 2 and 3. They just totally lost me, man. Yeah. It was like a 12-year gap between that shit.
Right, yeah.
And I couldn't manage anymore. Life was different for me. I couldn't get back into Kingdom Hearts as easily. But this looks nice.
It looks okay. I'm almost certainly not gonna play it.
I didn't see Goofy and fucking Donald and all of them in there again. Is it possible that they're not?
Oh no,
a
dude.
Part of this?
They're right here.
Oh god
and
damn it!
They're
man.
Literally looking for Sora in hell. And I saw a tweet earlier that was like, "Imagine your best friend dies, and the first place you go look for them is in hell after they die."
Absolutely. Well, they look nice graphic wise, but it's still Goofy and Donald Duck doing a bunch of goofy ass shit. So I think we'll get a similar result as we have in the past.
I will say the theme song, Hikaru Utada, "Simple and Clean," fucking banger, absolute banger. Love that. Love her. But Kingdom Hearts itself could really give a fuck about. Don't dislike it. Just really don't care. It didn't catch me when I was like into fan fiction enough to really graft to something like that. I was kind of coming out of like my forum signature weeb fan fiction phase when Kingdom Hearts was getting really popular, and it just didn't do it for me.
I'm just surprised that like Square Enix has been able to hold on to this Disney license for this fucking long.
Yeah.
Disney
Good
is expensive
point.
And like I figured Disney would have been tired of this shit already and be like, all right, we're not doing that again because we're Disney and we don't like to do anything to have fun. So
right.
I'm surprised that Disney is still like down with this. I thought that relationship would have expired by now.
Yeah, what sort of blackmail does Square Enix have on the Disney CEO?
Yeah, because the slant of who benefits more is very, very slanted in Square Enix ball court, because Disney, they don't really get much from this.
That's crazy. They really have Mickey Mouse out here in hell wielding
Mickey
a gun blade.
Mouse. fighting Cloud from Final Fantasy and shit, bro. Like, that does nothing for Disney. That only improves Square Enix's position.
Yeah, so. I wonder if maybe that was like a cocaine business bender or something. Or like, oh, dude, we'll give you a license, man, to all the Disney properties. And like, you're telling me...
For years. You can do it for 20 years.
We can have Goofy punch Elsa from Frozen in the face with a, while having a sword. And they're like, yeah, dude, it's fine. Go for it. So, it's fine. Shout out to Square Enix for whatever black magic they did there.
Yep. Very surprised that that is still going.
Well, that's the only gamer news we have today. No disrespect to the final or to the Kingdom Hearts fans. It's just not for me personally, man. I don't know.
Yuck.
Said many of our viewers in the chat.
Mickey Impromptu. Yeah, that is a very Final Fantasy Disney blend right
Square
there.
Enix and From Software need to make a joint game? That'd be kind of tight. Shout out FromSoft, man. Congratulations.
That'd be kind of scary as fuck, man.
Yeah, that would be
scary.
That'd
be so depressing. Like, just Mickey just trounging through the underworld, fighting just skull dickhead monsters with three knives for eyes and type shit, man. Like, not fun. Nightmares.
Aloxa said, I'm a gamer, and RealGamer261 responded to him and said, same.
Yeah, Real Gamer is a gamer, for real.
All right, well, let's crack out some of the ridiculous articles that we might not be able to talk about once we are on the front page in minutes here and just get right into it. NLE Choppa tweets about pooping 5 to 7 times a day. And no, not NLE sends 5 to 7 tweets about pooping. He issued a long series of tweets about how you're supposed to poop 5 to 7 times a day.
Yeah, anybody unfamiliar with NLE Choppa, I am not the biggest NLE Choppa knower or appreciator. But he's obviously a rapper that has in the past few years really shocked everybody with his like stance on being really organic and like vegan and alkaline water and just real woke ass shit that you wouldn't expect from somebody named NLE Choppa.
Triple Mac says, I take all of NLE Choppa's health advice seriously
and now I have diabetes.
Yeah, NLE Choppa definitely just a rap Dr. Sebi almost, man, with a lot of different potions and sea mosses for you.
Yes.
But I think that that's the appeal, man. I think that's why everybody likes him.
Yo, also, we missed some resubs. Watermelon Bro, welcome back for 25 months. FJ Finn back for 36 months. And Hippie Rhetoric back for 11. Thank you guys very much. We appreciate that. He says, I'm so healthy, I shit at least 5 to 7 times a day. Consistent vowel movements mean the body is caught up to what's on the stomach currently, not what's been bloating in you. Vowel movements often mean healing. If you're not using the restroom at least 2 times a day, not good, 100 emoji.
Not good.
And then he also 100. Says, I shit 5 to 7 times because I eat a lot because I fast even more. So when I come off my fast, I'd be ready to eat. Since the food is alkaline, it runs right through me. Moral of the story, you should shit for every meal.
All right. Sound medical advice from NLE Choppa. Any doctors in the chat who've dealt with bowel movements before, let us know if this is true or if NLE Choppa is just chopping up some bullshit.
I don't know, man. He's in so deep with like the esoteric, like almost borderline occult shit that I cannot even discern any part of what he's saying.
I just don't know. I just haven't heard I don't know his music like that. I don't know his songs like that. I just always hear him talking about, you know, just organic shit.
What, Buff Dyack in the chat said, paging Dr. Chopper.
paging Dr. Chopper. Dr. Chopper to surgery.
Dr. Chopper over. How many times am I supposed to shit in one day?
I shit that amount, says Charlie Torque. Well, according to NLE
Dude,
Chopper,
you're
healthy, man.
You're healthy as
Congrats.
Hell. James Darko Force as a nurse once told me she shit like 3 times a week.
Oh, now that doesn't sound healthy. Just at a normal human bowel movements, that doesn't sound right.
Choppa said, I must not come. My life force energy is eternal, says Sarah.
My fair man, that was Joey Badass that said that.
Oh,
not NLE Choppa. Wrong rapper.
I bet you if I Google search NLE Choppa semen retention.
Oh, you think he on that too?
He's got to be.
He's got to be on that same page, man.
Dude. Hold on. Let's wait for this article to load here.
Let's see, man. I'm pretty sure.
Wait, it's even worse.
There we go.
He says one nut is equivalent to like 8 miles.
8 miles of what?
I don't know, man.
Of like real estate, or am I running, or what do you mean 8 miles?
Well,
the movie with Eminem.
he said, for context. Oh, so. It's commonly known as edging. He's an advocate for edging. We got to get this article done in the next 4 minutes because we're about to hit the front page. Various unconfirmed benefits come from semen retention. Anoli Chapa dished on the practice during a recent appearance in the Breakfast Club, saying he didn't hold back. Do I really want to click this? What does he mean about the 8 miles, though?
That movie with Eminem where he was rapping against other people, one nut is the equivalent of 8 Mile, man. Like, and that's a fucking long movie, so I would slow down on all the nut.
Well, Anneli Choppa says if you have ever ejaculated and you do not shit between 5 to 7 times a day, you're really unhealthy and you got to fix your life.
Oloxta said, holding life force vibes. That man retaining, y'all. Well, unfortunately, I retain... not by choice, man. I'm just retaining just because the sex ain't there, but like, not by choice. I feel you.
You only get one shot, says Maker Gaines in the chat.
Yep. 8 miles. Or what if I run 8 miles? Can I bust a nut after that?
I don't know what the math that is like, that he's doing, man.
That like balance it out. Like, all right, I ran 8 miles. Now I can bust. I don't got to retain the nut now. I can just.
Liam James says one nut equals everybody in the 313. Put your motherfucking hands up and follow me. Hey, yeah. Let's go, dude.
Thank you, Liam James, for getting my fucking angle here, man. I knew there was something shit in there.
All right, well. I'm unhealthy AF, says Dreas989 in the chat, nutting all the time and shitting once a week.
Oh, God. Yeah, that sounds terrible. So, Anneli Choppa is not all the way wrong here, man. So, poop a little bit more than once a week.
Yes.
And don't nut all the time, because if you just nutting like 4 or 5 times a day, like, I think that is probably damaging your body somehow. Yeah, you know?
Definitely. A beat matching and cum measurement stream, says Ari Flux. We got to tell that to the front page viewers.
Yeah, you can learn a lot of shit here, man. Like, we don't hold back the information.
Santiago, meanwhile, says, oh, God, no, in the chat with no context, referring to anything we've just been talking about.
Okay, Vladimir Poopin.
Oh, God. All right, well, I'm so healthy. Well, everyone, compare your semen retention statistics and the amount of times that you poop in the chat or in the Discord, I guess. And we'll come to a consensus of who's the healthiest. Also, Peter Popolini, thank you for the 4 months. Dumob, let's welcome go back for 7 months. Miller Bird, welcome back for 3 months. He says 3 shits today to celebrate 3 months. And that's Pokemontis, tight. 34 months. Many of the OGs resubbing today. Pokemontis,
let's go,
FJ Finn, Proper Po Man. Thank you, everyone. We appreciate that.
Oh, boy,
all
we
right.
Do.
All right, well, now that we got the semen retention talk out of the way and the shit retention talk, what about practicing shit retention? Is that a real thing?
I think that does the opposite of give you good health. It'll probably get you infected or probably get your bowels. You need surgery.
That's almost certainly not good, so don't do that. All right, anyway, man, feature chat just gets hung up sometime. Anyway, let's... One says mobs in the chat.
What are we wanting for?
Brown magic, says Candy Trips.
Hey, well, wait a minute.
All right, we got to keep doing the news here. Let's get into a segment that we just invented immediately before the stream today. New segment alert. This one is called the Twitter Roundup is what we'll call it here on the stream. We rounded up all the cool
Twitter
tweets.
Twitter Roundup.
Yeah, that's... Can you do that every time we do it?
Twitter Roundup.
Yeah, it's that time for the Twitter Roundup, where we round up all the tweets that were posted in the stream news section of the Discord and look really quickly at some of the zaniest and wackiest. Why did Young General So say he boot too big for he goddamn feet in the future? Thank you for that.
We love that.
Starting with the Twitter Roundup today, it's tonight's title tweet. I've passed by the store that was closed for months. Today the metal gate was a little open and I saw it's just full of mayo.
That's right, everybody. We finally found it. Small mayo door into Narnia.
Small mayo door into Narnia. Small mayo door into Narnia.
It's right there in some random New York street, man. I hope that one day we'll get one of you guys to visit that and tell us if it's real or not.
Yeah.
I'm in disbelief.
The
right
only
now.
Thing that's concerning to me about this is the small door that implies it's for like a mayo gremlin or hobgoblin to enter and leave through.
Ah, the gremlins and goblins keep making their appearance on this street, man. I definitely think it is a mayo gremlin that comes in there at night and just licks the tops of each jar of mayo and screws it back on.
Only real male lovers get a membership.
Disgusting.
Okay, can we get a 1 in the chat if you are a downright mayo enthusiast? And a 2 in the chat if you really strongly dislike mayo. I got a 2. I don't like mayo, although I switch up immediately for aioli.
Yeah, I'm 1.5, man. Like, I oftentimes don't like for the restaurant to decide how much mayo they want to give me. I'm like, put it on the side, put the aioli or whatever on the side, and let me decide how I want to slather it on. Because nothing worse than a restaurant ruining your goddamn food with just a big blob of mayo on your shit.
Right.
Man.
Yeah, I agree. And if you get too much mayo, it starts to look a little suspicious, you know?
A little pausey.
too much mayo is terrible. What even is aioli? Yo, so that kind of blew my mind, because isn't aioli just mayo mixed in with something else?
Yeah, usually it's mayo mixed in with a, sometimes mayo and I feel like chipotle kind of sauce. Mayo mixed with pesto sometimes turns into aioli. There's garlic aioli. There's a bunch of different, you know, methods to just spice up. It's just spicy mayo, man. Yeah. Like, they really don't do too
much.
Dude,
I'm a real, I'll switch up real quick, dude. Like, I really don't like mayo, but as soon as you put an aioli in front of me, I'm like, yes, an aioli. Very refined and nice, and I'll dip my fries in it and stuff.
It takes the sour out. Aiolis are never, like, sour. Yeah. That's the part about mayo that always is, like, kind of weird. It's a little soury in there, but aiolis don't do that, and they just have a nice, you know, chipotle aftertaste to them.
Nona says, fuck any mayo hater that claims to like ranch. Ranch is just mayo. Y'all hypocrites.
What about blue cheese? Oh, that's cheese.
I like blue cheese a lot. Yeah, leave blue cheese out of this. Blue cheese is perfectly nice. Well, if anyone wants to crawl into the mayo chamber as tribute and pull some mayo out of there through the goblin hole, the guy actually posted the address of where it is. It's somewhere between East 110th and East 112th on 3rd Avenue in New York City. So the mayo hole has been doxed.
What's with New York, man? And I feel like those type of little doors exist so many places in New York, man. Just little small, creepy, cubby, secret doors.
Yeah, sometimes when I'm walking around in New York, there's just guys opening, like, the holes in the street and, like, loading shit. And I'm like, what are you doing in there?
The ground gremlins are all popping out under the Chinese restaurants. I'm like, what are you coming from under there for, man?
Right.
It's a fucking manhole.
Well,
right,
some of you may remember, we actually did a full sudden death about a guy popping out of a hole in New York.
And he threw a flashbang at a unsuspecting brunch guest.
It was a smoke flare. Like,
oh, okay. Thought he threw the flashbang at some brunch goers, man, and fucked the whole brunch up.
Yes. There's got to be an aioli den, says James Darko. For I'll crawl up and get cozy in the aioli den, but you can't drag me into the mayo den. You know.
No. I'll wait for the aioli den for sure.
A guy also fell in a rat hole. Reminds us, says Markov.
Oh, man, just classic Mystery School moments right there, man.
Yes.
Love it. Definitely. The rat hole guy was a legend.
All you hear is Mario Underground music before that dude popped out of the manhole. Yes, they're popping out left, right, and center, man. All right, well, continuing the Twitter roundup on today's Mystery School stream, we've got the Oakley Sunglass Company headquarters.
Yeah. Is it titties on an alien, or it's alien titties, or a Star Wars
bank?
Bank.
Yeah. This is the headquarters of Oakley Sunglasses, y'all. I think as gaudy as Oakley Sunglasses are, I did not expect them to live in a strange Blade Runner Star Wars cave.
Yeah, shit looking like the Dune movie set. Jaguar Germ, you're absolutely right about that.
True.
The nipples on the front of this building are really catching me off guard, though. I don't know if I need those there, but...
Yo, General So says, shit look like an Unreal Tournament level.
Yeah.
True. But this is kinda bunny hopping around here shooting my plasma rifle.
Yeah, I do want to get into a PvP in this place for some reason.
For real.
It gives me that vibe, but honestly, kind of cool. Not bad, man. I fuck with weird shit like that.
The funniest part to me is all of the employees just walking around inside as if this is just a normal place of work. As if you're not in, like, a goblin bank on a moon of Mars.
Which raises a higher question of how much money has Oakley Shades made in this past 15 years? Because they fucking balling, it looks like, man.
Yeah, to be able to afford this Oakley time chamber here.
Yeah, they balling.
A
supremely balling.
Yeah, well, anyone wants to take a visit to the Oakley Sunglass... Consortium headquarters, You know where it is and what it looks like now. Search the eyewear industry.
I actually work there. The ongoing joke is, my glasses are up here, boys. Oh, you work at Oakley?
Or you work at the Oakley Mega Center.
Yeah. If you work at the Mega Center, let us know in the chat. I would really like to ask some questions about
you
that.
You work there? My pops used to sell fake Oakleys in the park, LOL.
little different little different execution right there. Not sure if your dad would have got invited to the headquarters from his bootleg Oakley entrepreneurial shit.
Thank you for telling us that, man. We will not report him to Oakley Corporate. You have our word, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we need to talk, says Peter Pablo. Yo, Ray J says Oakless. Oh, no, Oakleys.
Right. Jazzy Jewel said Folkleys. Your dad was selling the Folkleys in Central Park.
Yo,
man,
GK all day. Thank you for the 23-month resub, man. I appreciate that.
Wow.
All right, well, there's the Oakley headquarters. And you want to do the Twitter roundup intro again for the last one today?
Twitter roundup.
Yes, it's time for the last Twitter roundup post of the day. 30 minutes into my shift, and a customer gives me a sword of vodka.
Damn.
You drinking out of the Vord?
This is definitely a short sword of Smirnoff. The Smirnoff short sword right there.
Yeah, that's cool. I, for one, like anything shaped like a sword if it's not supposed to be a sword. A gun, a drink, another sword.
Man, what do you think the, that probably gives you like plus 30 alcohol damage or plus 30 like liver damage every time you hit an enemy with that one, man.
Yeah. I would be a little worried about transporting it so it doesn't break all over the back of your Hyundai on the way home, but
No, you just wear like Link from Zelda and just strap it on your back with a little sword and walk around with it, man.
James Darko says it would be hard not to swing it around. Oh my god, okay, that just gave me a fucking brain blast. Press 1 in the chat if you, as a child, or maybe adult still, are a chronic sufferer of wield things that look like swords as a sword disorder. I'm talking like that extendable part of the vacuum. You know what I'm talking about? Like you can pull that shit out. Maybe like a coat hanger or like that back scratcher thing. You know, a cane. You just use that like you got the gut instinct to just grip that shit and wield it like a sword. One all day, my whole life.
Yeah, I'm definitely there with you guys, but I'm more of a gun guy. I like gun shaped yeah. things, and I'm like, oh, pew, 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 pew,
yeah.
TV remote. Pew,
yeah.
Some vice grips. Anything gun shape. I'm picking that shit
yeah.
up and
I feel like
it.
Gun wielding kids versus sword wielding kids are the shakers versus biters of the imagination
yeah.
world.
Yeah, yeah, that's true, man. Because yeah, the gun wielders like myself, we turned out a little different, man. Hopefully for the better, but I can't really verify that.
Wielders Anonymous is FJ Finn. Of the imagination world, yeah, exactly.
I got my cousin suspended from school one time, because he made me mad in class. He ripped up a bunch of my robot drawings because we got into an argument, and then I proceeded to tell our fourth grade teacher that he ripped his Lunchables box into the shape of a gun, and he threatened me with it, and he held it at me, and then she was like,
"Oh, that's a suspendable offense. You got to go to the office."
Damn.
Cause he did. He turned it into
a
little gun.
You planted that fang on him.
He didn't exactly like blink, blap, blap, blap at me with it, but he did make it into the shape of a gun.
Wow.
And it was on his desk. And unfortunately, the evidence was
you
there.
You entrapped
that was
him.
To get him
you entrapped him with a...
Fuck him.
A fucking...
Shouldn't have ripped up my robot drawings, man.
Wow.
That was a real hater dick move.
Yeah,
so.
Dude. I mean, you know, he was playing with fire, and he had that that evidence lying prominently for all to see. So
damn,
he was kind of
like
asking for it.
I was like a dirty cop that day. I definitely like planted a little coke on his desk and told him like, "Hey, so yeah.
where'd this come from, dude? Right. You've been holding this all day, teacher. I think we got a problem,
yeah, dude. I think it was deserved, honestly. All things considered,
no, DeAndre, if you're out there, my bad.
Damn,
you've ripped up my robot pictures, man. Fuck it, dude.
You got entrapped. Holy shit. Does it look like we're on the front page right now?
Some form of a page, not the front one though.
Let's try out our new experimental heckling marketing device. All right, any first-time chatters here? Did that work? Did that work for anyone?
All right, well, we'll see. The viewership jumped up a little bit, so maybe it worked. We'll see.
first time shatters? No, no first time shatters yet. I think we got to do it like mid sudden death. Just bust that shit out.
That felt Nardwar-esque.
Nice.
Yes.
All right, well, we're on the front page right now, on the front page of Twitch, so if you see new people coming on in, make sure to welcome them, explain to them what the stream is, give them, actually, you can't give them a dime bag of weed.
Nickel bag?
Nickel bag is TOS. A dime bag is over the legal limit.
It's over the limit, all right.
So, Young Borna says, hi, what's up, man? Good to see you.
Yeah. Oh, well. I think it worked. We are on a page right now. Welcome to everybody coming from the front page, side page, or the back page. It's the Mystery School stream. I'm your host, Soulja Boy Tellem, right here. This is my boy, Liam Neeson.
Yep.
And we're ready to stream for you guys all night long.
Mm-hmm. For real. Yo, front page. Everyone click in and follow this shit, man. Oh, wait, I mean this shoot, man. I can't say that. It's fine. First rapper to have a late night show, says Watermelon Bro. That's true. If you're new here, if you send a first time chat in the chat, we will give you your own unique individual piece of misinformation about the current geopolitical environment of the world. We will straight up lie to you about where borders are drawn and global conflict.
Oh, nice.
Oh, Tic Tac Tech 2 says came through the side page first time. All right, dude, I got a piece of misinformation for you. The border of the state of Georgia was actually drawn by a guy who was blind, so it's about 200 meters off to the east.
And that's today's misinformation for that ass,
there
man.
You, go,
you
man.
Got it.
There we go. I got you, dude. Bones McRib, thank you for continuing that sub, man. I appreciate that. Oh, all right, let's keep doing. Let's keep going here, man. We got a bunch more news. I think we should gamble shortly, but
yeah.
For now, how much time we got? We got about 45 minutes until it's time for sudden death. If you're new to the Mystery School stream, we are going to be making a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you get to choose the topic based off of all the news that we're covering on the show tonight. That's going down 45 minutes from right now, so stick around and keep your favorite news articles in mind as we do the show.
Yes, and love us too. Love on us while we're here.
Yes.
You never know when we'll be gone.
You never know, man. All right, how about this? Check this out, everyone. Are you down with the microchip implant that lets you pay with your hand?
Bleep bloop, y'all bleeped up off the hand juice, because that microchip will definitely give you a little bit of hand disorder, mm-hmm. little arthritis or carpal tunnel syndrome.
Dude, this shit was like what conspiracy theorists were talking about for the past 40 years of New World Order and capitalism inside of our veins. But I think we're at a point now where the average person still probably is squeamish about this, but a couple years from now, people are going to be like, yeah, man, it's better than Venmo. Just slap it in me, dude.
To be honest, I would. I'm not even that scared of it right now, dude. Like,
right.
I don't know if I've given up as a man or right. as a human or whatever. But yeah. Like, at this point, man, after all the shit of these past 2 years, I'm just like, do what you want to me, man. Like, my body is yours. Just take it. Whatever you want to do. Just do some shit, man. Just promise me that I won't, you know, get in trouble or die.
Yeah, dude, imagine though all the exploits and shit. Like, if you don't have a RFID blocking wallet, people can just come by and scan your shit and take your information. Imagine you can, like, high five or shake up with someone and it's like, and they take all of your crypto or something, all your Bitcoin gets siphoned out from your wrists.
Damn, or just imagine, like, getting your ass kicked and knocked out on the ground, and then instead of going in your wallet and taking your money, they just grab your hand and just keep slapping it on the Cash
no,
app and just like draining
no.
your bank account until you're just on zero, yeah. man.
Dude, I think I've mentioned this anecdote on the stream a couple times. One time I was on the bus, I think it was 2015, maybe 2016, and this guy was like frantically explaining to his friend sitting next to him on the bus, like, how all the algorithms are listening to you, and it knows how to recommend you products, and it, like, knows what you're thinking, blah, blah. And this dude is going off for, like, half an hour, telling this crazy narrative of, like, how big tech is watching, and it's suggesting you products. The dude sitting next to him was just listening. The guy finished his rant, and the guy looked at him and went, I don't know, man. That sounds pretty convenient. And, like, that, I think, I've mentioned that on the stream multiple times, because, like, that sums up to me, I feel like, the average person in this day and age's attitude towards this sort of stuff. And while right now a lot of people are apathetic or you know, standoffish about something like this, I think we're pretty close to people being like, oh, well, you know, I already unlocked my phone with a facial scan and I'm in a database, so what's just a chip in my wrist to Venmo for a $20 coffee easier, you know?
Yeah, man, we're not that far off, and I know that we're not that far off just by my own, just like, I'm just kind of indifferent towards it. Like, in the past, I would have been like aggressively like, oh, no, hell no, I don't want a microchip.
Right.
But now I'm just like, I mean, maybe.
Depends on how convenient it is.
Yeah, it depends on the benefits that I'll get from it, because we're already like microchipped on our phones anyway. Like, we're being watched constantly. Yeah. So
the skin implant,
nothing different.
The skin implant's a little spooky. This is what it looks like, in case anyone wanted to know.
The skin plant?
It just goes right here. There's a couple different variations of it. There's one that goes in your wrist, too. I remember a guy in 2017 got one for his crypto wallet specifically embedded in his skin for some, like, transhumanism convention or something. I don't think it's convenient enough to have an RFID chip in my body. But, you know, when the government rounds us up and forcefully injects us with them anyway, it'll be fine.
That'll be fun almost, you know? Once we get forcefully rounded up to get injections, and then we all just running around bumping into each other, stealing money from each other by hand.
Trip to the microchip injection site.
I'm hugging everybody's grandma and stuff. Like, hey, grandma. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, nice to meet you too, other grandma. Beep, 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 beep.
Anyone want to go to the mystery school meetup at the FEMA camp? Mm-hmm. Hit us up.
Robbery's never been so easy with the microchip, man. Yeah. I like the sound of that.
Careful. My CAD teacher, Mr. Fash, predicted this in 07. This is like her fan. Dude, we got to get him on the stream. Mr. Fash, come on the stream, dude.
Yeah, you sound like a real futurist, man.
Bones McRib says 10% off your next footlong when purchased with your wrist chip. Dude, mark my words, 10 years down the line from this moment in time right now, there will be advertisements like that.
Yeah, if they give me a tax break or something, I'll put that inside of myself, man.
Yeah. Not a Cave Bear says, I'm not getting a chip in my hand with my money on it until I can figure out how to make IUDs not disappear into the air. Ooh, IUDs? That's a conversation for another time. Scary.
Spooky.
We need male contraception now. Feeling like Mr. Fashion 07, says Peter Popolini. Nice. All right, pay with your body.
Pay with your soul.
Imagine your hand vibrating when there's a discount nearby. Yo, that reminds me of the article we did a couple months ago of there was a patent filed by Ford to suck advertisements from billboards you pass by onto the windshield of your car, right? While
that's
you're
really
driving.
Sick. Man, yeah, I would honestly like that. And I would also love if, like, my microchip, every time I try to make a transaction and I don't have sufficient funds,
it hurts
and it's
you?
Like, yeah, it like just instantly like electrocutes the shit out of you. He's like, insufficient funds.
Like, oh, hey, sorry. You see, you don't have enough funds on your card right now. You can either use some cash, or we can do the payment option where we convert the physical pain you're feeling into electrical impulses that mine a little bit of Bitcoin. And you can just sit there.
That's a future I'm here for.
For 20 minutes, and then you pay off your debt with the Bitcoin mining that was done.
Just a little torture, and you can get your potbelly sandwich for $9.99.
Yeah,
man.
Nice.
Just a little torture.
That's the future that we're all working towards. Am I right? So there was an article we were going to do, but I forgot we were on the front page, and the title of it is "Electric Shock to." Actually, never mind. I'm not even gonna spoil this. We'll just talk about it on Wednesday. And speaking of, hey, front page people, come on in.
Come on in.
It's all fun. Come on in to the Mystery School stream.
Touches. It's all sticky in here. Come on in and take a seat.
Yep. Hop on in. Shio K says, stream feeling hella dystopian tonight. Also, Shio K, thank you so much for the 9-month resub. Appreciate that very much.
Nice.
All right. Let's keep it going here. Or should we gamble?
Maybe. A gamble might suffice right now. Let's do that.
Okay, let's gamble a little bit. Also, tonight's Let Us In Your House segment is brought to you by showing us something that you think we specifically, as in me and him, will hate in the Discord.
Really disappoint me, man. Really disappoint me and my friend here. Show us something that we just would be really underwhelmed by or just disappointed
well,
in.
There's
man.
Some shit in here, man.
Yeah.
Please head to the Discord and post some of that. There's a big conversation going on. All right, anyway, what's the gamble?
All right, next gamble here. We'll do this one for 3 articles. We will not include ads. This will be article only for this next gamble. I want to see a pure the next couple articles, pure and devoid of robotics. We've been talking about so much technology and robot stuff. What if for the next 3 articles... if there is no type of robotics or mechanics shown in the picture,
so totally
the main picture, the organic article. Yes, organic article, main picture only. If the article has multiple pictures, does not count. Only the first picture of the next 3 articles. If there are any types of inorganic material or machinery, like electronics and robotic stuff, then the gamble is off.
Oh, man, there are some bad things being posted in the Discord.
Yeah, mechanic seems broad. Yeah, electronic, I should say. No electronics in the article first picture for the next three articles.
Nice, okay. Gaming chat guys are cool, says Demob444. Oh, yeah, the gamers are currently squatting in the gaming chat of the Discord, but we're at peace with them. We're not going to evict them. It's fine.
Yeah, somebody go tell them we're streaming right now, too, if they want to join or hang out.
Ask if they want to hop in the stream. All right, well, let's throw it to the Discord here. When this gamble goes up, we will see what you all think we will specifically not like today.
Let's see. What don't we like?
Okay, well, kicking it off, let's see here. What do we got? What are we working with? Fergmethazine says booby progress. Oh, that's nice. I like that.
Wait.
Aww.
Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Hold on. So, click that cat again? Why is it?
I think.
Is it a full? I'm feeling like I'm having a stroke, dude. Is it like a full cat or is this like?
I think he's like scratching his head or something.
Yeah, he looks like he's not a full cat. I'm missing a lot of cat here.
And then he posted a picture of his litter box.
Yeah, don't like.
I do
dislike
hate
that.
You're right. The Kringle, welcome back for 18 months. Jazzy Jules, welcome back for 20 months, man. Good to see you.
Never had a cat, but I don't like when they poop.
I hate that. Seraphim, watching us while playing pool.
Oh, that screen is huge compared to the screen you got the Mystery School stream on, so I definitely don't like that.
I don't know. I don't hate it. I don't hate it. I kind of like it, actually.
I kind of like the apple dapples. I was about to... I kind of like the apple dapples, man.
What about prongles?
Oh, yeah, hate that.
it's already like...
Prongles.
The prongles come pre-chomped, it appears.
What rabid orc created that brand, man?
Oh, that's our tweet. Drunk AF on the SSN, back to Vermilion City Part 2.
I like that. That's tight. You want to... Drunk Pokemon cruise?
I do hate cruise ships, though, so this does track for me. So that that one passes.
Some Owen hate there.
Moldy cucumbers I had to reject at work, says Fugitive Oak.
Oh, my God, brother. My brother in Christ, man.
Yeah.
At least scrape that off for the penicillin.
Oh, man.
Know?
Yeah. Okay, let's keep scrolling. This cupboard I refuse to clean. Oh, just in general.
I don't hate that.
It's fine. It's a little annoying, I guess, but...
No, hate is a strong word, and I don't feel hate for that.
This unreasonably large weed container, says Mr. Beige.
Oh, I mean, God. Just put more weed in there.
How many? I didn't realize that there was dispensaries that sold this amount of weed in a official container.
Yeah, just put more, refill it with a bunch of weed, and then it's a regular container holding weed.
It's confusing and a bit concerning, but I don't mind. It reminds me of a prop in a video game or something.
No, not mad at that.
Got these at a job fair.
Are those Geico in-ear earphones, man? Yeah, those will probably work for about 4 hours before spitting electrical sparks into your ear.
Or every time you, like, press play or skip forward or backwards on a song, it goes,
Geico, ask how much you can save on your car insurance.
Yep, that would be tight. We hate those here.
Geico earbuds. Slicker with a potato?
What that is?
That's a potato that appears to be flowering.
That's beautiful, man. I don't hate that. That's really interesting science right there. Yeah. I don't hate that.
I actually kind of like that. Okay. Yeah. Well,
don't eat that potato. Leave that potato alive.
Chat, we'll have time to check in later on. Oh, God. There's a lot going on.
Tuba Gordy. I knew somebody was going to do it. Thank you, Markov.
Tuba Gordy. We'll check in on the Discord to see more things that we hate in today's Let Us In Your House segment. But for now, we got more news to do because sudden death is coming up in 35 minutes from this moment in time right now. 36 minutes, actually.
Wow, get prepared.
Laker fans, the grip on that potato, crazy.
Demon fruit. Yeah, that did look like a demon fruit of some sort.
True. Also, hey, front page people.
Yes, yo, front page, you just click into the stream, click into the stream, click into the stream.
Click
in. Do you like when I do this?
Whoa.
Do you like it when I do this right here, front page?
All right, we're testing our new front page conversion strategy here on Mystery School Stream. We'll see how effective it is. If that worked and you clicked into the stream, please let us know and we will reward you with a custom piece of disinformation.
Yes, that should work sufficiently. I think that this will work wonderfully.
All right, well, speaking of disinformation, we have an entire segment about just that today.
The Today Show fell for a hoax that an Ed Sheeran impersonator was on the run.
Oh, man. Ed Sheeran fell on hard times.
Ed Sheeran fell on meth, looks like, man. Ed Sheeran has fallen on a sheet of glass, if you will.
Oh, and oh no, says Chris McFaulton. Yeah, wait, this confused me. I thought that the guy tricked the Today Show, but I guess he did trick the Today Show, not into thinking he was Ed Sheeran, thinking that he was on the run.
Oh, so the Today Show was like,
definitely not Ed Sheeran. We're not stupid, but he could be on the run from the law. We should investigate this guy.
So I didn't hear about this. Let's see what's going on here. A very obviously fake post about a fugitive Ed Sheeran lookalike managed to dupe the team over the Today Show. It all began when newsreader Tracy Vo announced a major manhunt underway in the United States. The Ohio Fugitive Task Force is hunting a con man who's been taking cash from churches, fooling them into thinking he's Ed Sheeran. The host found it hilarious that the con man in question looked nothing like Ed Sheeran, but the actual joke was that no such con man exists, and anything more than a cursory glance at the post would show it was satire. According to the post, local fugitive Ronnie Williams Jr. was wanted for fraud after he performed Shape of You at a church for $35 and a sandwich.
Wait a minute! Yo, hold on. I did not think this would take such a pleasant turn like this. I love stories like that. So this gentleman here, he impersonated Ed Sheeran at a church concert.
Yes, and then did Shape of You and got paid $35 and a sandwich, and that
and
triggered,
was paid $35 and a sandy.
That triggered,
I think that's
a fugitive manhunt, though.
So wait, what's the big deal? Like, so they got mad at him after that and was like,
"We just paid him $35 and a sandy. I need to call the cops."
Yes. Like, no, man, sometimes you just got to get jugged, man. Like, get wrecked, man. Yeah,
but
fake Ed Sheeran.
That never happened.
You, but
that this guy was never impersonating Ed Sheeran. He never performed. He never got $35 in a sandwich. Someone just asserted that this happened, and then there was a manhunt for him, and the Today Show was like, oh, that's real.
Oh, somebody completely created a false narrative for our man, Ed Sheeran,
right there. Also,
damn,
Chad,
I wish he would have did it.
What is his Ed Sheeran impersonator name? But yeah, no, the funny thing was that they just asserted this guy scammed for $35 in a sandwich, and they called the feds on him. And then everyone was like, that's a real story, and then just reported on it without fact-checking.
This dude probably got arrested for that, man. Yeah. Like, he should sue the Today Show, honestly, right, man, because he probably was minding his own Ted Sheeran business.
Ted Sheeran.
Before being dragged out of his one-bedroom apartment by the police.
Yo, I aspire to one day create misinformation at this level where you just say a bold-faced lie that's easily unverifiable, and then it just sets off a media firestorm. Maybe we should do one dedicated misinformation article a day.
Should we start a misinformation? Let's start a mystery school misinformation. Yeah. Mystery information.
That's
man.
Like back in the day, very occasionally one of our mods would slip in an article that was very obviously fake. And we would just start to read it and realize halfway through, like, hey, wait a second. And it would keep us on our toes because we would never know for sure which articles were fake or not. And we had to do some investigation during the stream. I like that.
Yeah, shout out my boy, Bed Shearman. BK, thank you for that sub, too.
Welcome back for 2 months. Appreciate that. Thank you. It's a misdirection, says Old Clay Toad. Yes, very, very true.
Yeah. Jaguar Germ, sometimes you do just gotta take the jug. If you get jugged, sometimes you don't call the police, y'all. Like, if somebody jugs you fair and square, yeah, don't call the police. Just like, take your jug and return the favor to somebody else and jug them.
I was fairly and duly jugged by this fine gentleman, and I concede the jug hath been done to me.
That's fair. That's a gentleman's approach, man. Don't call the cops if you get fairly jugged.
For $35 and a sandwich. Yeah, let alone, like, calling an APB on a task force, a government task force.
I think that's just kind of petty and immature, in my opinion.
Speaking of an article that's not petty and immature, check this one out. Lil Durk lookalike shuts down Florida Mall.
Let's go, man. My boy, Big Durkio, or Smirkio, as he likes to be called out in public. He strikes again, man. I've seen this dude on Twitter and Instagram for the past, like, 2 weeks.
He really fucking looks like Lil Durk.
He kind of gave me Tyga vibes right there,
yeah,
but
he looks close enough to Lil Durk that if you were not exactly sure what Lil Durk looked like and you briefly glanced at his Wikipedia, you would be like, oh, that's Lil Durk.
Yeah, yeah, that's right. He's definitely the fraud, a little Dirk. And this dude, honestly, has been doing pretty well off of this, from what I understand. Like, he's doing appearances.
Scamming? Or, like, everyone knows he's an impersonator?
Yeah, people know, like, oh, we want fake little Dirk. Like, he's doing a real, like, press tour, and, like, this dude is getting bread right now from being fake Dirk.
I think his name should be, I just put it in the chat.
We're Luigi.
He's just Little Dirk, D-I-R-K, like a knife, you know?
Little Dirk.
Little Dirk.
Little D-E-R-K, Little Dirk.
Yeah, Little Dirk is his official name as an impersonator.
Y'all feeling Little Dirk in the chat? Go ahead and type Little Dirk in the chat little if you like Dirk. Him where we deal with that one.
Just a Little Dirk.
Nope, Watermelon Bro, not Lil Dirk. We said Little Dirk.
The only people
D-I-R-K.
Who lose in these situations are the enthusiastic fans who... are like, yo, it's me and my homie here, dude. We're going to the moon. And, like, it's a double L because you got finessed by the imposter and it proves you don't know what they actually look like.
Yeah. Honestly, I want Little Dirk. I would definitely want to take some pics with him. And, like, oh, man, I wonder if they should start an agency of, like, these kind of, like, impersonators. And I would like to, like, book them for shows and stuff and, like, have them open up until I get cease and desist.
Yeah.
And be like, dang.
Lil Dirk opening for the cool kids. Yeah. Tyga opening for the cool kids
just, like,
tonight, man.
Poorly,
slide through, y'all.
Poorly lip sync to their own songs. Like,
dude, that'd be so easy to, easy to finesse, man. I'm honestly thinking about that because... they trolled me enough. The music industry's trolled me back and forth since I began here, man. It's about time I get my revenge.
Yeah,
man.
Dude, we gotta just start hiring imposters to open for our shows.
I don't mind that. That would be fun. I think that's how we should open up the Mystery School Live era when we go on tour.
Bring
with
out
the stream.
A bunch of doppelgangers.
Yeah, and they perform, like, they open up for us, and then we do the stream after
I think,
man.
That's a great idea, honestly.
Yeah, I think everybody would like that.
So, Chad, you ever been told that you look like someone? You ever been told that you could be a doppelganger? The one that I get all the time from many people in the stream is this one.
Let's go. Rami Malek, let's go! I knew it, man!
I don't look like him, even though this image makes me look like him.
You're him, brother. My brother in Christ, you're Mr. Robot, all right?
It's not me! I don't look like Rami Malek.
Dude, man, like, I don't know what to tell you. The proof is in the pudding right here on this photo, man. Like, everybody sees it. But, I mean, there's worse people to look like. Yeah. He's cool. He's
I like
cool
Rami
dude, man.
Malek, man. Rami Malek, come on the stream. We're on the front page. I know he's out there listening to this.
At least you don't look like several C-level basketball players like me, man.
Oh, yeah.
I don't really like the references I get.
Seraphim says, you look like Mr. Robot if he did weed instead of pills. Hey, I'll take it.
Weed Mr. Robot.
Tony looks like Paul George. I see it, but not. My mom doesn't think I look like Rami Malek, so, you know, take that.
Yeah, that's all good, man.
They fucking you up. This is Honey Butter in the chat. Damn. All right, well, we got some doppelgangers in the chat right now. I used to get called The Weeknd when I had long hair.
Wow, yeah, I can see that, man. Yeah, I've only been called, like, Paul George, John Wall, Paul George. It's just always an NBA guy with a similar shape head, man. That's usually
definitely.
It.
I saw Lord Rockwell say he's the 6'5 Timothée Chalamet. I can attest
everybody
to that.
In the chat, let us know who you look like, because I'm interested. I see a D Rose out here. Charlie Torque, you look like Tyler, the Creator. Now I can put a face to what you guys look like, because all I know is your names. I haven't seen your faces that much.
I'll envision that they're these people that they're saying they are.
Vic Versace said, they said I look like Prince. Prince Harry or the singer, man?
Damn.
Like, you got to specify, brother.
I look like the Keebler Elf. Young General So says, I just got hit with an ad. Hashtag ad.
Ooh. Sorry.
How many articles did they get to see if there was something organic?
Just three.
So number one, number two. Wait, dude, number two. There's hella electrical components here.
Yeah. Yeah. Wait, no. Yeah.
Yep.
There is some electrical components.
Yeah.
Yep.
We can pay out the bet that there
that out.
Was hella electrical stuff. Push a T, says Mercenary Gary.
Push a T-shirt.
Nice. Displays. All right. I'm pissed at this ad. Says Laker. Damn, Laker fan is a gifter, but has.
Damn. How you? What? It's a cold world out there. Laker fan gifting subs, and y'all letting him rock without a sub,
Tick
dude.
Tick West saving General So though. Thank you, Tick
what
the
hell is going on in this world, man?
All right. I got compared to A Boogie, says Unique in the chat.
With said hoodie or?
A Boogie without a hoodie. Okay. Anyway, we got 25 minutes before it's time for sudden death and the perfect amount of articles to get through. And Markov with the gifted sub to Laker fan. Markov, thank
somebody
you.
Somebody save Laker fan from this purgatory he's living in, man.
Buff Dyack says, I made a twisted tea cannon out of PVC pipe. So... All right, I'll just put it up for a second just to see if they, you know, we like subliminal message anyone.
Hopefully. We'll see if this works because we're finessing tonight. Mystery School fraud at an all-time high today.
Yes.
I'm a fan.
Yeah, we got impersonators, doppelgangers, fraudulent methods.
We are literally like hijacking our front page position to lure unsuspecting viewers into this stream by using... subversive methods.
Leave it up longer? Okay, we'll do it longer next time. It doesn't seem to be working so far, but have we hit like the front page yet, or are we just kind of on the side page?
We're on the side of a page.
Okay, all right. Well, side page viewers watching the stream right now, come on in. We don't bite. Unless you're... Actually, never mind.
Unless you want me.
You need a concealed carry to have a twisted T on you. Rich Homie Cable with the Prime sub. Thank you very much, man. Appreciate
Let's go, Rich Homie.
All right, let's keep it going. Leave it on for the whole time. This is Kanye 20.
Do the stream with the goddamn banner up like that, man. I like that.
All right. Well, we're not quite in the Method Watch yet, but we are definitely getting there. To start things off, Wisconsin man accused of slapping boys over missing frog.
Oh, no. Not boys. Not the boys.
Yeah, I hope this isn't a thinly veiled euphemism either. But
missing frog.
The frog went missing and he began to slap, according to this article.
Frog went missing and man went pissing. Don't touch a man's frog, man. You know the rules.
Yeah, this happened in Sheboygan, Wisconsin. Sheboygan man is charged with... Sometimes I just say Sheboygan to myself. I said that to River the other day. I just looked at her and went, Sheboygan, just because it's a nice word.
And how'd she react?
She went like this.
She said, thank you, sir, for the Sheboygan.
Yeah. A Sheboygan man is charged with slapping two young boys for letting his pet frog escape briefly. Oh, and so it didn't even go...
Yeah, I feel him, dude. Like, I had pet frogs
as a reptile owner, as a child.
Yeah. As a reptile owner, yeah, I will slap some children if they let my pet frog get slightly away from his enclosure, man. You deserve to get slapped in your little nugget head, man.
Damn. Wait, Markov says this article's from 2011?
So that doesn't make it any less valuable. We're still learning something
here,
man.
We have some fucking breaking news here on the Mystery School stream.
Why'd you have to snitch, Markov? I was loving that article, dude.
Who posted this? All right, we need everyone to go to the stream news section and narc on whoever posted this old article, but I'm glad it's here, and we're still talking about it nonetheless.
And, guys, we also do appreciate it. When you post things like this, we like that.
You can post
more old, weird articles and see if we catch it. We don't mind.
It's like a freaky scavenger hunt. Oh, shoot! Some purple stuff with a 5 gifted subs.
You get a small milli rock for that, man.
Thank you. Thank you so much for the 5 and supporting the stream, man. We really appreciate that. And BKWGFC says, new to me. And that's how I feel. We are continuing with this article.
New to me. Because I think that more kids should get slapped for letting frogs
a frog loose. Christopher D. Sipe, 26, faces a preliminary hearing Wednesday on 2 counts of felony child abuse. Sheboygan Press Report says, Sipe was living with the boy's mother. Oh, damn, so he was fucking their mom, and they let his frog out for a bit, and he went, Papa!
You stupid little son of a bitch! I'm railing your mom, and I'm about to... I should knock the teeth out of your head. You let Mr. Pibbles out, man!
Wow. Well, this article really paints a picture of the family dynamic that was going on in the household here.
Damn, man. All for a frog.
Told investigators that even after it was found, he acknowledged hitting the boys, quote, very hard because he thought they were responsible.
You let my goddamn frog out. I told you not to touch him.
It's Richard, says most of our chatters.
It's definitely Richard.
This is definitely Richard move right here. Plantscape, thank you for the 300 bits, man. Appreciate that. Prosecutors say Sipe had been drinking before he struck the... Oh, yeah, dude.
Oh, this just gets better and better, man. That was always... That was always my worst fear as a kid, man. my parents get a divorce, and then my mom remarries a dude that's drinking and having frogs, and then one day he slaps the shit out of me because I let it out, man.
Okay, we here at Mystery School formally decry slapping the shit out of a child for
hell no, man.
Letting a frog loose. Okay, don't do that. Child abuse is very bad.
You talk to that child after he let your frog out sternly, mm-hmm. but you don't slap him in his mouth because the frog went 3 feet in the other direction.
What you can do is stage an elaborate ruse where the frog narrowly escapes death by a like elaborately constructed, you know, Rube Goldberg machine, and then you save it at the last minute to teach your children the importance of being attentive. You know, you can do that. But that, you know, you might as well just make sure that they don't let the frog out.
So. Taylor Jane, with a very astute observation, the kids were like, oh, shit, it's a frog.
Then let
it out.
It
was just kids seeing a cool frog, and they let it out. And dude just immediately ripped a hole into him. That's not fair,
real
man.
Real bastard method here on this last one. We do have a palate cleanser, though. A conflict that we can all agree on as justified and reasonable for this next article, however. Check this one out. Texas man beat roommate with stick over argument about what mosquitoes look like.
What the mosquito look like? What does it look like?
Was his roommate like, oh, it looks like this? He was like, you're lying!
He was like,
I told you about this several times. Mosquitoes look like this.
You make me explain this again. What was their discrepancy? Yeah, that's a good question. I don't know. Like, how could you improperly describe a mosquito to the point it aggravates someone to hit you?
I mean, what do they actually? They don't really look like anything, to be honest, man. They're just annoying. There's little wings, and then there's like a sharp face, and that's all I can really see, man. Like, how do you mess that description up? I don't understand.
Yeah, I'm not sure. A Texas man charged with assault beat his roommate with a wooden stick after a pre-dawn fight Sunday stemming from an argument about mosquitoes. Victor, 43, attacked his roommate and left him needing stitches.
Bro was 43 years old arguing about mosquitoes, bro. Like,
what the mosquito look like?
What you doing, my man?
Officers responded to the residence at about 2:42. The roommate told police that Shavers assaulted him shortly after they argued about what a mosquito looks like. The affidavit says the argument escalated into a physical fight when Shavers told his roommate that he, in fact, did not know what the insect looked like, while the roommate argued otherwise. Shavers then grabbed a stick behind his bed and started hitting his roommate. The roommate managed to grab a metal bat from his closet and hit Shavers while defending himself.
You know what the hell a mosquito looked like, bro. Don't you sit here in my face and tell me you don't know what it looked like. As a matter of fact, I'll kill you right here. Oh, I'll finish this off.
Damn, man. He just didn't know what it looked like, dude. It didn't need to go. You could have Googled it.
He said, bro, you know what this don't. You gonna sit here in my face and on Al Gore's internet and tell me you don't know what a mosquito looks like?
Remember right
I'll
now.
I'll kill you right here.
Damn, man. It's not that serious. Wow.
Grab me my switch, says Moving White. Somebody definitely went and grabbed a switch,
damn,
man.
Wait, the roommate grabbed a metal bat? In retaliation, yeah.
Yeah, after being assaulted with a stick.
For being punished for not knowing what a mosquito looks like.
Wow, anyway. Man, I'm scared of my friends that are into nature at that level where it becomes violent. I don't want anybody to like animals that much, man.
I think that the moral of the story is that mosquitoes suck ass and cause this conflict. If there is, like, I know if you just erase an entire species from the world, it'll cause catastrophic effects to the food chain.
We've heard.
I don't care. Mosquitoes are useless and everyone hates them. Just get them out of here, yeet them into space, whatever has to be done.
Yeah, because even the guys that eat them ain't that cool. Like, what eats them? Just like,
oh, well, bats are cool. Spiders eat them.
Oh, spiders, I guess. Yeah, okay. But spiders can honestly get the hell out of here too, for the most part.
That's fine.
So, in conclusion, mosquitoes can definitely leave.
Right,
they can go away.
Diamonds Forever says mosquitoes literally suck ass. They do. They literally suck on your ass.
Amongst a lot of other things, they suck.
Some Purple Stuff says I blame the mosquito for not being more identifiable. Yeah, that could have caused or solved this whole problem. No one would have fought if they just were able to look like something normal, you know?
Yeah. Try to be a dragonfly or something noticeable.
Indeed. Also, I think it's time for this. Whoa!
If you're on the front page, come into our stream. We put the sign up and we're not mean. Right now...
Front page viewers,
What's up? Click on in. Come on down to the Mystery School stream, y'all. It's working, says Crash Fleet. Click on in, everyone. Yo, you know you want to watch this. This is it. Yo, come on, y'all. We haven't gotten one new person to acknowledge this. This is a failure of a new method, dude. I don't think this is ever going to work, and I'm embarrassed that we even tried this today, man.
Hey, man, I think we'll see the real conversion at the end. We may have only got two extra followers today, but we got to keep trying.
Wow, man, yeah. All right, well, it's a good idea. Let's keep it going.
Diamonds Forever says, people leaving, LOL.
They are. The viewership has dropped 50% since we posted that last.
All right, well, I know what'll get them back on in here. We got 15 minutes until it's time for sudden death. And, computer.
Yo.
Take us to the crime dimension.
All right. Strap in, fucker.
Help!
Oh, no.
Nice.
We pop back up in the crime dimension, and I got my crime mask on, and it looks like we're about to talk about today's best and worst crimes on the internet, man. This is the Method Watch right here.
It's been a little while since we did a Method Watch, so can we please get at least one Method emote in the chat, if you would not mind? We'd appreciate it.
Lace them up. Hit that chat, man.
So we can blow through these methods pretty quick. I think if we go quick, we got enough time to gamble if you want, but I'll leave it up to you, man.
All right. When should we launch a gamble?
We could do it now. If we're going to do it, we should do it now.
All right. Let's do it, man. This gamble will go for the remainder of the stream. I think we got enough articles left. This will include ads as well. I'll allow article and ads. And what we're trying to see here is... I guess in light of our last article here, that really inspired me, man. I want to know if we'll see a phallic object in the foreseeable future of the stream. See if we can find a phallic object. Ads, they're included, man. It needs to be something being held. A phallic object needs to be held. It can't just be sitting there doing its own thing. It needs to be held in human hands.
Okay.
We got... the rest of the stream to see
and
if we can make
count?
This happen. Ads do count.
All right. Fair enough. Obelisk, asks Unique inquisitively.
Yes. If it's being held, yes. Yeah. So I guess with that, should we go into the Discord and see what the Let Us In Your House segment is provided for
us? Yeah. Today's Let Us In Your House segment was brought to you by posting things you think we will hate in the Discord. Last, we ended off on this weird potato growing a bunch of cool plants, which we actually kind of ended up liking, honestly.
Oh, some real cool fern gully type shit.
My frat paddle. It's not mine.
Ooh, hate that. Don't like it.
It also
frats
says Lil Bro on it.
Frats got to get spanked all hard, man. I don't like it.
I don't like fraternal orders. Charlie Tork posts lube job.
Yep. Hate that, dude. Oh, super penetrant. And why is he so, like...
Look at how he's gripping like that, very seductively.
No, look at his face and his eyes as he sprays the lube on his, like, lower nut.
Yeah.
Like, why is he so, like...
That is literally officially his lower nut right there. Oh, yeah, I don't know about that one, man. I don't like that one.
I do hate that.
Christian Politan says he is suffering because he has to stay in here while we clean up his pee from the kitchen floor.
It's a wrinkly Sharpay. I was like, what is that I'm looking at? Nice Sharpay.
I hate it that he's suffering. I like it that he's here.
Yeah, I don't hate this. I like that.
Nice. Wrinkly, very, very nice. Dog. Thick and rough oatmeal?
Yep. Definitely don't like that.
Don't like it. Not a cave bear. Don't like it.
Thick and rough.
Oh, God.
Like, why your oatmeal just called me a opposite gang? Like, what's going on?
Ari Flux. 166,000 points.
Wow.
That's nice. I like that. I'm happy for your financial success, Ariflux.
Keep coming up.
Nice. Yep. Oh, she won two in a row. Ariflux, very, very impressive. Damn, Ari, you came up. Strippy Maru in the chat. Very, very nice. All right, well, we did hate a lot of those things that were posted, but not as much as you might think, you know?
Nah, I'm trying to hate things a little bit more, so guys, try harder.
Yeah, I agree. Okay, we got time for a handful more articles before it's time for sudden death. If you're new to the stream or you're watching from the front page, we are about to make a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you choose the topic based on all the articles we cover on the stream. That ski mask actually has remarkable head tracking, dude. It even goes down your neck when you turn your neck up.
Right? I'm a professional ski mask wearer at this point.
Periwinkle says BDSM oats for the thick and rough oats.
Them oats edging me right now, dude? I don't like it.
Indeed they are. All right. Well, rapid fire through these remaining articles. Check this out.
Thieves steal over $22,000 in cheese wheels from Dutch dairy farm.
Big business in cheese, man.
Yeah. If anyone is in the market for black market cheese, keep an eye out on Craigslist or other similar platforms for this re-rocked cheese.
Yeah. I wonder where do you sell stolen cheese at?
You think, like, the theft gives it a different taste? The crime of it? It marinades in the criminality of it all?
Yeah, and they probably leave it in the trunk of, like, a Nissan Maxima for, like, 4 days before they start selling it. Yeah, so that changes the flavor,
the stolen
too.
Cheese buyers are like, yes, I want the taste of the forbidden cheese.
Yeah, I guess it's like eating an exotic animal or something, right. You know? Like, I
just had tiger tonight.
Damn, a Dutch dairy farmer walked into his shed to milk his cows one morning last week and was shocked to see that thieves had broken in overnight and helped themselves to over 60 cheeses. The oversized cheese wheels weighed 10 kilograms or 22 pounds each. So, so the farming couple from the town of Finart. I'm really sorry. That's Finart?
Fart.
They must have been hurriedly hauled away in a wheelbarrow, but they're less concerned about how and more than they are about the why they were targeted, especially since they're now down $22,000 worth of cheese.
Damn, man. Man, cheese is expensive, though, man, to be honest. Especially when you're getting that Kraft cheese and that, I'm not the brand Kraft, but like that specialty cheese, Havarti and
Pepper Jack.
Brie cheese and all that type of stuff. When you get it on the wheel, like those old timey cartoons, those are like $100, man. Like,
for
those
real.
Cheese wheels ain't no joke.
Dude, I would say the two costs that surprised me the most about adulthood were the cost of cheese and rugs. Everything else I figured costed a lot of money, but I was like, damn, cheese. A pack of Pepper Jack cheese is like $7.
A pack of that Peppy Jack, man. Mm-hmm. So be careful. Just try to steal it if you can.
Yeah, I'm gonna start.
The price is up too.
Start buying some cut PJ, you know, for the low.
Yeah, you can get some re-rock cheese. You got to go onto the right blocks though.
Right.
You got to hit the right blocks on the south side and grab some.
Some
cut
purple
cheese.
Stuff says 20K in cheese. People hitting slightly devious licks. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's like of all the things you could steal. It's not quite wholesome enough to be like, how could you do that? And it's not hardcore enough to be like, wow, a hardened criminal. It's just like a slightly devious lick.
Yeah, I mean, if you get 20K, that's devious, man. They robbed him for 20K, point blank, man.
That's true.
And he got off.
That is devious. Yeah. All right, well, let's go to the flip side of this.
Thieves steal 500-ton iron bridge in India.
So we broke the bridge down into small slats and loaded it up on a truck to take and rebuild somewhere else?
Absolutely no idea how any of this happened or why. We got some W's in the chat right now. A gang of crafty scrap metal thieves dismantled and decamped with a 500-ton defunct iron bridge in East India, pulling off the unlikely heist by pretending to be irrigation officials. The robbing of the bridge was reported on Wednesday. Police officer Subhash Kumar told AFP that the thieves came in the guise of government irrigation officials. They brought in bulldozers and gas cutters and tore apart the structure before escaping with the booty over 2 days.
What are you going to do with a dismantled bridge, though? Like, who's the consumer for that?
They'll probably just sell the scrap to, like, scrap buyers. And that was, like, a lick of just a shitload of scrap in one place.
Wow. Honestly, not surprised, and I do think this is a real story because, it can happen, especially in a just random bridge part of India right here. They're
right.
Probably like, yeah, I guess these guys look official. Fuck it, let them have it.
And like, who's gonna show if it's an old ass, busted ass bridge anyway? And you're like, oh, yeah, we're here to look at the bridge for 3 days. Everyone's gonna be like, have fun, loser. Like, that's fine.
We hate this bridge, dude. It sucks. It's cutting me all the time. Yeah. I walk on it, I'm getting
tetanus
by the day.
This bridge.
Yeah. I would say, 9 out of 10 lick right there.
Honestly,
they hit a good lick there, man.
It was a well thought out plan. Scrap metal's at an all time high right now, says James Darko. I believe it, man. Construction materials are expensive as hell, so maybe they came up huge off that.
Oh, so if we want to build new constructions, we should start just stealing material from other people's constructions. And
I don't know if we should, but you can. That is true.
I'll be willing to take my risk because bricks are up by at least 60% right now. So if you guys see any old buildings, let me know. All I'll definitely chip away at the brick and use it to build myself a house.
The Zines in the chat says, oh, this is some good bridge metal. You bring out the bridge metal tester. Beep, 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 beep. Testing the bridge metal.
Oh, like a diamond tester almost.
Periwinkle says, Fortnite in real life. Yes, also true.
Yeah, you need the material.
Bob X says, get the fuck away from my material, asshole.
Yeah.
That is a lot of material,
be
man.
Careful, man.
A brick costs as much as a brick. Yeah.
Poorly guarded inflation. Construction site is a gold mine, suspiciously says Dreas.
Dreas? Like, do you know something about this? Is this something that you might have dabbled in before? Because you sound
Dude,
confident.
The scrap
like
metal
it.
Thief fandom overlaps huge with the Mystery School viewers.
He said, a poorly guarded construction site is a gold mine. Oh. Oh yes. You little metal orc, you stealing scrap metal
Goblin?
Out there? Damn, bro.
Kango says, it's a nice hobby. Yeah, breaking into construction sites and stealing their materials. It's just a hobby. Don't worry about it. It's fine.
I mean, as a child, I used to like to go into unguarded construction sites and, like, play hide and seek and run around, but I didn't steal anything.
The quality of this scrap metal in this unguarded construction site is quite pristine.
Nothing more enticing than an unguarded construction site. They've left all of this gold here on the floor.
Oh, shit. Look out. Guard your construction sites, dear viewers. That's what we learned from this stream today.
Yeah, some construction goblins out there that want to take your scrap metal and loose wood. So.
All Black Zach quietly says, how much are you getting for bridge materials?
Hey, a lot in this economy, man.
Yeah, you might want to hop on the black market and see.
Free Drowsy? Yeah, where's Drowsy at, man? I know he could weigh in on stealing construction materials. We got a whole range of viewers who don't even know who that is now at this point.
Wow. Shout out to our new viewers here tuning in, man. In case you didn't know, this is Mystery School. We're currently in the crime dimension of our stream where we talk about today's best and worst crimes. And if you're scared here, it's okay because I am too, man. Yeah. Just hug me. Try to hold on to my arm for the rest of the stream real tight.
Just hold on.
I won't let you go.
Just hold on tight and we'll get through this together. We got a couple more articles here. Actually, I think we got just enough time. We got a nice method alert. Well, actually, only partially. Get those emotes ready in the chat. Robber returns money to store clerk, saying it's not enough to help sick daughter. Well, actually, nothing about this is nice.
That's
actually kind of depressing in all aspects now that I think about it.
Damn, man.
Oh, that's from 3 years ago.
Not enough to help St. John. Yeah, that sucks, man. I'm sorry to that man and to that
curse. Damn, this article actually sucks, dude.
Death sad, says Rich Homie Doge. Yeah.
Well, okay, palate cleanser. Don't worry. Forget that article because we got Traveler who was told by the TSA he had a cane in his sword, had no idea. Sorry, a sword in his cane, or depending on which way you ask, it could be either.
Nice, man. Any Ronald Isley fans out there, you seen that video he did back in the day when he said, what the hell is going on between these sheets within my home? And then he pulled out a cane with a sword in it on R. Kelly and the girl that he was cheating with, man. Damn. So let's shout out old cane knives. Those are always efficient.
I was going to ask anything that people brought through the airport on accident, but I don't want people to admit to federal crimes, even if they were accidental, in the Mystery School chat. So we'll just say, damn, that would be crazy to learn suddenly you had a sword in your cane. You think he knew, though, and was like, oh, I had no idea. And at home, he's like,
no, this person probably bought that from, like, an antique shop or something and didn't know that it was a secret sword in it. Like,
yeah.
That happens.
Yo, secret sword is a really cool kind of sword, honestly.
It's the coolest type of sword. Yeah. What do you mean, man?
Right, you're right.
A sword,
dude,
that was from something else that you didn't know was a sword? Like,
right.
That's kind of fire, man.
FJ Finn says, second only to a gunbrella.
Yeah, you got a point there, nice, man. That is fire.
That is pretty cool. Transportation Security Administration officers at Boston's Logan International Airport discovered a long blade inside a traveler's cane on Tuesday. The man said he had no idea the blade was in there. After being questioned by the Massachusetts State Police, the man surrendered the cane and was cleared to continue his travels. It's not uncommon for blades to be concealed in seemingly ordinary objects. That's ominous. Yeah. I mean, just going to leave us with that?
A TSA? Can you give me a little bit more confidence before I fly?
Wow.
Like,
yeah, there's a story I want to tell about an accident that happened to me in this similar way, but I won't incriminate myself.
That sword looks sharp, bro. Like,
yeah.
It doesn't look like the type to, like, do a slice, but a good stab? That one looks like the one right there. Yeah. That'll stab you real good.
That one does look kind of scary. Happened to my uncle, says BKWGFC. Nice. Or sorry, to your uncle, I guess.
Ari Flux said, TSA let you have anything as long as it's not inconvenient to them.
Yeah, that's true.
And that is very true. I've been told that by a TSA agent in so many words.
So have I. Don't want to talk about any further on the stream, especially not on the front page, but that's true.
Anyway, that's the last article. Well, there's one more article, but I don't know, man. It's just now time for sudden death.
Well, I guess that gamble has finally paid out. Let's get into sudden death, man. I think we should have saved those articles for the next stream. Stockpile a few of those hits, you know?
I agree. Markov says, TSA has touched my meat multiple times.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that's they're supposed to do that. Or yeah, they want to do that.
I thought that was part of their job, I think. But
maybe they just like it, you know?
Yeah, I agree. All right. Well, anyway, now that we talked about that a little bit, it's time for a segment called Sudden Death, where we make a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you choose the topic based on the articles we covered on the stream tonight. So we're about to really quickly go back over the articles we covered in about 60 seconds or so here. Keep your favorite three in mind, sometimes four or five, depending on how many bangers we have, and we will put them in a poll. Whichever option wins that poll, we're making a full song about live in under 30 minutes.
It's CM Gordon said, hello, I brought tacos.
Hey.
Let's go. Did you come here because you saw our SOS, like Morse code message that we left on the...
Did it work? Did this work for one person or did you just
Did this work
on
for
listen?
One person?
Either way,
I'm
thank
trying
you.
To see.
Thank you for bringing tacos. We really appreciate that, man. Thank you very much.
Well, that's right. Tight anyway, regardless.
So here's everything that we talked about on the stream today. Keep your favorite articles in mind, please. The new Kingdom Hearts, where Sora got doxxed IRL and doesn't have funky shoes anymore.
Oh, no. We don't need a Kingdom Hearts freestyle today. Okay, how do we describe this? Let's see.
Oh, maybe terrible medical advice freestyle?
Yeah, okay. Yep, I like that.
Yeah, nice. Bad I actually like that one a lot. Freestyle.
Yeah, that's good.
We got the secret mayo door in New York.
Need that, yeah.
Nice.
Secret mayo door.
We got the Oakley Sunglass Palace.
Oakley Dune Palace. All right.
We got the vodka sword.
Okay, vodka sword, I like that. That's nice.
Put a chip in your hand.
Microchip
freestyle.
Got that.
Nice. Sudden death topic. Poorly guarded construction sites. Sister Reyes.
Hey, that's not off the table.
That's fine. Ted Sheeran. Or just like, maybe there's something about the doppelganger articles here.
Yeah, just do doppelganger freestyle.
Okay. We got... the. I don't know.
Man accuses slapping boys over... Don't touch my frog freestyle.
Yeah, nice.
All right.
And what a mosquito look like freestyle.
I like that. What mosquito look like. Got it.
We got some good ones tonight, such as cheese theft.
Nice, not bad. Cheese theft is cool. Oh, we got some options today.
And stealing the bridge, a.k.a. poorly guarded construction site freestyle.
Yes, I think I like that the best. Poorly guarded construction sites is where we need to go.
And that's pretty much it, man, other than the cane, but I don't think we got anything from that.
Yeah. All right, so it looks like we got quite a few options for this evening. While he's getting ready to set up the beat-making technology and all that good stuff, I am going to go through some of the top articles of the evening with you guys in the chat, and then we'll create a poll where you get to vote for tonight's sudden death topic, man. How do you guys like that?
Sounds good. We got some good ones in the chat right now.
All right.
I like also, I love terrible medical advice from rappers. I think that's one that's for sure my vote.
That's in there. Terrible medical advice is in there for sure. Also, I think that poorly guarded construction sites, I like that one a
that
lot.
That one is pretty funny.
I need that one.
Yeah.
No, I guess I'll let everybody else decide the other two.
Yeah, what other ones you guys want?
Cheese heist. I see. Don't touch my frogs. Steal the bridge. Oh. All right. I'm seeing some love for the cheese. So let's go do cheese theft. Cheese theft is the third. And let's get one more just for posterity here. Let's do what a mosquito look like.
Nice.
What a mosquito look like. All right. So, Kix, right. If you're out there, I got today's top four sudden death articles here. They are poorly guarded construction sites, what a mosquito look like, cheese theft, and bad medical advice from rappers.
Nice.
today's top four sudden death articles. We're going to create a poll on that, and you guys will get the vote. This is sudden death.
Love it, man. All right, and speaking of, while the poll's coming up, I got something to show you, everyone. And that is the Mystery School Radio playlist that you, dear viewer, can access by typing ?playlist in the chat. Recently, freshly updated. And I'm going to be updating it a little bit more. We're getting close to 1,000 likes. We are merely 18 likes away.
Give them to us.
Can we get 18 more likes on this? I've been curating this playlist for like 4 years now. Just type ?playlist in the chat, man. Help us out.
All right. The poll is up and running right now. We got terrible medical advice. Not in the lead. It was just
really?
In the lead. Poorly guarded construction site is in a random weird lead right now.
Also, chat, you got to use your bits and channel points to vote. I know that there's going to be some weirdness going on.
You have to.
If you want one of these topics to win, spend your channel points or else someone else will on the option you don't want.
We got some whales in the chat too, man. They heavy hitters, so make sure you use those channel points and bits. It's the only way to make a difference out here, man.
Yes, yes. Terrible medical advice is catching up, but poorly guarded construction site is in a heavy lead right now.
I wonder what it's going to be. I'm not mad at either one of those now.
Geezy Legend with the 12-month resub, a full year. Thank you very much.
Geezy.
We appreciate that very much. Oh, terrible medical advice rocketed into the lead after Kix informed our viewers that there's a sale on votes right now.
Oh, my God. Yo, use those channel points. You got to do it now.
Uh-oh.
Poorly guarded construction site has slipped behind by a lot right now. Terrible medical advice is in the lead. Up, but it's creeping back up.
Yo. Poorly guarded construction site is starting to creep up. If you want terrible medical advice to win, you got to spend some points, man. You got to spend some points.
Use those channel points, man. What else are you going to do with them? You better do it now. The clock is ticking. If you want your topic to be chosen for tonight's sudden death, spin that bag, you know?
Yeah, spin that bag.
Channel points in the air.
Terrible medical advice is still in a bit of a healthy lead, unlike the topic itself.
Oh, we got a whale at work here. Looks like...
Seconds left.
Wait. Seconds left.
Also, LTCM Dr. Gordon says, my brother is a huge fan. I'm working right now and always get tacos from my restaurant.
Man, if you were around, I would love to try some of those work tacos.
Terrible medical advice. It's tonight's topic. And I can't say I am mad about it.
No, this one is strong. It's full of content. And I think that we'll get a good sudden death out of this one.
Yes, absolutely. All right. Also, let me just add something here. So during sudden death, I can go like this just in case it happens, man, where I'm not giving up on this strategy.
I like how it gets real quiet when that happens, too. Like every time that comes up, everything goes silent and then we just stare at the screen.
So let's find bad medical advice type beat here. Look at all these new samples I got for sudden death today. Let's see what we got going on here.
Terrible medical advice. I'm feeling like, you know those commercials where they're like, hey, this new pill has a bunch of stuff that'll make you feel good, but
the side effects are you will die, you will shit your whole entire bowels out, and then you'll be locked into hell with Satan himself for 3 months.
We got some good options here.
Some purple stuff. Thank you for that gifted sub. No. Okay. Hold on. No. I know what I'm looking for. This.
You like that one?
Yes. That one right there.
Yeah, that's a terrible medical advice type beat right there.
I'm getting that medical vibe from that one. I like that. No. Yes.
Yes.
They're very different, these two samples, but they both give me that like medical commercial vibe.
Yeah. I actually do kind of like this one, getting awful advice over a beat like this.
Yeah. It's like,
do not pop this pill unless prescribed by your unofficial doctor who is not licensed to prescribe medicine.
It makes me kind of want to see if we can replace the first one.
What's the first one?
The first one was this one.
Okay. Yeah. All right, yeah, that one can go.
Let's see.
That can
go.
That one, I'm feeling bad medical advice on that one.
Okay, yeah, let's replace the first one with this one, and then we can take our vote.
Okay.
All right, I like Kix, you can go ahead and put the poll up. Chat, what are we about to make this beat out of here? We'll play the samples when the poll is up right now. Also, let's heckle our viewers on the front page. Come on in. Come on down to the Mystery School stream. We're about to make a full song live in under 30 minutes. The poll is up.
Better be here.
Poll is up right now. Here's option one. Option one right here.
Cast those votes right now. It's option number one.
Option one. Bad medical advice freestyle. You got option two right here.
Oh. Mm. Oh, it's pretty good, dude.
Option two is off to a healthy start right now,
option
man.
Option two
is running it up.
Oh, option two is taking
option
off.
Option two is taking off. But there's still time for option one. If y'all cast those votes, man, you still got time. Use those channel points and bits. You never know.
Option one right here. No, dude, it's going to be option two for sure.
It's two. Two got it. All right, we can close the poll. It's over with, man.
It's over.
Option two has won, and tonight's sudden death shall commence.
Let me make sure this is on time, and we're going to get it started here. Yeah, we're good.
I think we're good to go.
Okay, it's time. Chat, you know the deal. If you're new here, you don't know the deal, so I don't blame you. This segment is called Sudden Death. We're about to make a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you voted on the topic based on tonight's news that we covered on the stream. There's a couple other details that you got to know about how sudden death works. The first is that we got a timer up here in the top of the stream. At the 20-minute mark, it's time for the chat sample. You get to pick any sound that goes in the beat. It could be a weird sound. It could be a bad sound. It could be something that'll make the beat slap harder. Just let it rip in the chat. Our moderator, Kicks the Flare, is going to pick out whichever one he thinks is the best and send it to me. If we don't use it in the track, we fail tonight's sudden death challenge. At the 10-minute mark, it's time for chat words. You get to pick any three words that he has to say in tonight's raps, or else we fail sudden death. You submit those the same. Just let him rock in the chat. Our moderators are going to pick him out and then make us suffer as soon as they are chosen. So, without further ado, should we just get it started, man? Bad medical advice freestyle?
Here we go, man. I'm ready to give out some disinformation and misinformation, so get ready to be led to an early grave, guys. I got you.
The timer has begun. Also, I forgot to ask, sudden death emotes in the chat, please.
Oh. All right. So, how this works, in case you're a new viewer here, we need you in the chat. Help us out with the rap here. Let us know some of your best lines about being a bad doctor, giving bad medical information and advice, man. I think that everybody has had a little experience with that in their lives, man. Doesn't gotta rhyme, doesn't gotta be a rap. Just throw some concepts in the chat. I'll try to tie them into the rap the best that I can. It's a sudden death. Oh, that's a fire sample, actually.
It's a really nice sample.
Let me see if I can come up with a hook real quick. Oh, is there a way we can do auto-tune today?
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Definitely got auto-tune today. All right, that's the low one. We got the high one here.
Our boy Dieverbotinzal just typed E for their first ever.
That's what I'm talking about.
Their first ever text here. Just E. Oh, looks like we got some Abraham ID as well, first time chatter.
What's going on, man? All right, let's get this
up. And it, there it goes. And they said, I'm going now.
Thank you. See you later, dude. Thanks for tuning in.
See you guys later.
That's what we're talking about on the Mystery School stream.
Relax for the longer version. How do you want it? Okay. Yeah, I got it. Yeah, Lame funny. James in the chat with some bars already. Yo, look, you gotta shit five times a day. Chewing on red mulch makes headaches go away. Throwing an apple at a doctor, I bet they go away. COVID ain't real. I literally made it up. It was really fun. I don't give a fuck. You should wear a mask if you're ugly. Ugly is a disease I can cure for a couple hundred. Lame James, that was a real trip right
chaotic
there,
chaotic bars from Lame James, getting it started today.
Loving that. A lot of first-time chatters. Welcome all our first-time chatters. Hope that we caught you with our weird fishnet of a scam of making that message appear on our screen. Hope you're here for this. Fat Tamal, thank you.
This is a snare type here.
Hell yeah, snare. I just woke up.
I actually kind of like that one. We need like a rap snare in here. Let's see. You like the tempo? Should I speed it up a little bit?
No, I like this tempo.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, that's it right there. Okay. That's what I wanted. Okay, okay. How are the bars?
Bars going great so far. I got a hook idea that I'm working on right now that I think should be fire. Okay, we got 26 minutes left on the clock. This is sudden death. Let's go. I'm feeling free. Keep it. It's gone anyway. This person is very interesting. I love the way that they type.
It's the bad medical advice freestyle. Wait, going, and then we are off to the races here. What up, new front page viewers? Come on in, click into the stream. What's going on? Whoa!
come here now. You getting tricked by the algorithm at this point?
Yeah. Let's. If you got psyoped into the stream by clicking on this, please let us know.
Let's go, man. Thank you for all our new viewers out there taking a chance and throwing your bars in the chat. Just write something cool about today's topic, which is giving bad medical advice. You don't gotta rhyme. You don't gotta be a rap. Just throw something funny or something in there. I'm a good rapper, so I'll be able to figure it out. Don't you worry about the hard part. Yeah. Yeah. Take a look inside my room.
That's it right there. Grab that.
Ooh. We got 24 minutes on the clock, y'all. Sudden death is underway. What do we do? First?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Let me get back into the chat, see if I can find some bars. I got a crazy hook already, because I'm a great rapper, and that's just how it goes. But now I got to get into these verses. Groovy General with some bars for the first time. This is one medical suggestion you don't want to miss. It's 5 to 10 minutes after sex. Make sure you get up and take a piss. Yeah, I like that, Groovy General. You got me on that one.
Okay, I don't think we need all that many drum sounds here. You just gotta let the soul speak on this one.
Yeah, and you know, I think that the sample octave changes and all that stuff is pretty cool. So you don't need a lot of drum sounds. All
right, let me just put a couple
antioxidants and adaptogens, clean label only aspirin. Oh,
nice.
Yeah, I like that.
All right, let me put a couple little things in here, like an open hat, for instance. percussions too. Like a rim. Not that. Maybe that. That's what I'm looking for. All right. We are well on our way. How much time we got? 21 minutes? Okay, it's right about time for the chat sample. I'm not exactly panicking, but I'm not exactly not panicking. Let's see.
Yeah. 21 minutes. 21 minutes on the clock. Sudden death is underway. Yeah. Yeah.
Our time is nostalgic. Just a little click click at the end there. Okay, chat, you're watching Sudden Death. If you're new here, we got 30 minutes to make a full song live on Twitch, and our viewers chose the topic tonight based on the news that we covered. Tonight's topic is bad medical advice. So we're about to drop two verses and a hook just chock full of the worst medical advice you've ever heard. So bad it would be considered malpractice and potentially illegal if we weren't entertainers here on Twitch.
Ah, yes. Good old medical information. Misinformation, man. My favorite. Get you grown.
At least that's how it goes.
Oh, I like that, Dr. Jones. Whiskey bath. Right.
Okay, I need like a classy drum loop occasionally to go on top of this, too.
Dr. Mario throws pills at people to cause damage and smash, let that sink in. Some purple stuff, you're right about that. It's all a dream. I used to drink hydrochloroquine.
Oh, can you say
you
that?
You can't say that.
Hey. All right. It's time for the chat sample. What did you all pick for me today? Let's see. Kix, thank you for sending this to me. Okay. The sample has been acquired. Let's put it into Ableton here and see what you all have decided to torture me with.
Hell, Rail told me if I don't feel too well, can eat a clipped Newport and maybe some kale. Thank you.
What is this? Okay, here's the sample.
Herb quit smoking with Chantix and support. Talk to your doctor about Chantix and a support plan that's right for you.
Oh my God, what are we going to do with that?
Some people have changes in behavior, hostility, agitation, depressed mood, and suicidal thoughts or actions while taking or after stopping Chantix.
What the hell, bro?
Okay, I know what to do.
What are you going to do with that?
Some people have had changes in behavior, hostility, agitation, depressed mood, and suicidal thoughts or actions while taking or after stopping Chantix. If you notice agitation, hostility, depression,
We're going to do that for the intro.
Okay, got you. All right. Hey, if he makes it work, he makes it work, man.
What?
There's no loss in that. If he makes it work. This is sudden death.
Yeah, it's okay. We're going to get through this together, everyone. We're going to get through this chat. Also, front page viewers, come into the Mystery School stream. We're making a full song live in under 30 minutes. All right, back to making the beat. Okay, let's see what's going on here. Let me start with this.
I gotta move faster. I got 19 minutes on the clock.
Yeah, I'm dragging ass, dude. Oh, dude, this is actually about to go crazy. Hold on. I need to match the key to this, and then I think it'll work. This is gonna sound dissonant as hell. There's no way around it, but I wish this didn't have music in it. This is going to sound terrible for a second, chat. Sorry. I got to get the key right here.
Some people have had changes in behavior, hostility, agitation, depressed mood, and suicidal thoughts or actions while taking
medication. And
if you notice agitation, hostility, depression, or changes in behavior,
this sounds so bad. I'm just going to use it for a second. I'll figure that out later.
Yes, that has to only be in the intro.
It sounds terrible.
It will destroy everything else that has anything to do with this song.
And then this comes in.
Italy Choppa. Shout out my choppers in the chat. All my NLE choppers. NLE chopper says something's going to happen tomorrow.
Heroin is healthy, but a cure of your sorrows. It's purely organic. It boosts your immune system. It causes no damage. You don't need vitamins. Just lick a penny. All right.
Okay, I like that.
Okay, these guys here. I'm going too slow. I'm going much too slow today, chat. I'm not going to lie.
Pick one and lick it. sex, it'll make you last longer. All right, I like that.
Yes. Okay, we are well on our way here.
I can eat a clip Newport and make some kill.
I feel like we need some more, like, I want to put, like, some medical sounds in here or something.
Oh, do the, do you got the, like, the heart monitor sound?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Something like that might be cool.
Let me pull up Splice. I can probably do this through Splice.
We are at 16 minutes on the clock. Sudden Death is flying right now.
Oh, God. Sorry.
That was dysphoric and scary, man.
That played through the wrong thing. What is the name of that? Like, a cardio,
Oh, that I don't know. I call it a heart machine.
Heart monitor? Is that what I'm looking for? Yes, that's what we wanted. Okay, I'm gonna put that in the beat for the hook for sure, because this is terrible medical advice freestyle, and if you listen to this, you will need to be on probably assisted breathing is my guess. Okay, let me just grab one of these beeps here. I want, like, beep. Yeah.
Okay, I'm back in the chat looking for some bars as well, man. All my my clever people in the chat, throw your best bad medical advice in the chat right now. I'm gonna turn it into a rap somehow, some way.
It's a little off.
This is Sudden Death.
How much time we got? 15 minutes?
15. Bring it 72 says, yeah, you know the drill. Take the pill. Call it laxative. Because you know I'll so better be relaxed and shit. Wait.
Hey, yeah, it works.
It's somehow fun. It works. All right.
Beep in there now.
That's tight. Yep, you got it. That man is on a roll right now. Can't go sit. Stop touching. Just with your hands.
I love that Instagram and Twitter video.
Let me grab this.
It's going to be 12 bars.
Nice. 14 minutes left.
There we go. This is a real end of life type beat, honestly. Call your friends and loved ones in because you've taken horrible medical advice type beat.
Yes, you've taken medical advice from two dudes on Twitch at exactly 11 o'clock p.m.
Damn.
On a Monday. You probably shouldn't have, but you did, and now you're here. This actually is a banger, bro.
Thanks, man.
I like this.
Okay, beat's done. I just gotta put in some effects, and we're good. Okay, duplicate this bad boy here. What kind of effects do I need in here? I need a cymbal. Oh, I wanted, like, a classy drum loop. Let me find that. That's, I think, what I was looking for. Let's see. I want it, like, right before the hook hits. Oh, God. I don't know if I have time. I do like this one a lot. Yeah, I'm gonna put that one in. It's so off though. Oh God, okay, we're almost done here.
Dr. Oz told me it's okay, so everyone do talkie spray. A little particle ain't gonna do shit anyway. I can wear man. Oh, what would the troops say? Krolik 29 with bars in the chat. Thank y'all. If you're tuning in for the first time, thank you guys so much for dropping these bars in the chat. Y'all are actually great rappers, man.
Yeah, thanks for tuning in, everyone. We appreciate it. We're trying our best to make a full song from scratch live in under 30 minutes. You voted on the topic. Tonight's topic, was terrible medical advice freestyle. If you got some terrible medical advice to give us, drop it in the chat. It's about time to start rapping and recording the verse in a second here after I finish making the beat. Appreciate you tuning in. Also, hey, front page people, we know you're out there. We know you can hear me right now. Just come into the Mystery School stream. It's a nice place, man. It's
come in here.
It's a cool place to be. We're making a song.
Just get in here. We got cigarettes. Do you like cigs?
We need
your
help.
We'll give you a free one and a toenail clipper, man. And it's real sticky in here, too. So come on in and don't touch nothing.
It's fine. Just hop on in. It's okay. Just follow the stream. We're all friends here. We're all nice. We may give you terrible medical advice, but, you know, that's par for the course. All right. I need some cymbals, and then I'm done with the beat. Okay, I'm tweaking.
Okay.
That sounds like your life force training.
Malpractice insurance. Sam Strain, thank you for those bars. I like that, yeah. Took some blood thinners off Instagram. She's turned me blind and I grew a third hand. Rich homie dollars.
Instagram blood thinners?
Love that.
Put some little effects in here. Let's drop this guy. Okay. All right, beat's done.
Okay, awesome. All right, after chat words, I should be ready to go, man. 10 minutes on the clock. I'm sorry, 10 minutes. Let's go. I'm so healthy that I'm on Dr. Gunna and Umar diet. Whippets and no white women, you gotta try it. Kango, that is genius.
Kango.
Why are you like this? I'm writing that down.
Oh,
man.
No. Yo, that heartbeat monitor beep actually is kind of nice.
It does sound great.
All right, everyone. It's about time to start recording. Chat words are coming up in 30 seconds. If you got three words that he's got to say on the beat tonight, just let him rip in chat. Kicks the Flare is curating. Everyone here from the front page. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching the Mystery School stream. We're making a full song live in under 30 minutes. You chose the topic. You're helping us write the song right now. Here come the chat words, man. I'm gonna turn down the beat in the background.
All right, it's about that time, man. Let me see what we got here.
Sunday. Here we go. You ready to start recording after this?
Yeah, I think so. Today's three chat words that I have to incorporate into the rap are banana, Xanax, and kombucha. Ah. I gotta type those in and figure out how to make those fit into today's rap. That is today's chat words. Let me see what we're gonna do here, because those words don't rhyme with shit, actually.
We can make it work. We can do this.
We've done worse, so let me see. Banana, Xanax, kombucha. All right.
Banana, sussy, and oo-woo.
Xanax,
I think we've actually done all those words before.
Kombucha. I know we've done kombucha before.
All right, it's time to start recording.
It is. Let's do it, man. It's about that time.
All right, you are going to come in. Oh, you're going to want auto-tune on this, right?
Yes, please.
I'll do
please,
this
please.
While we're recording. I'll get it going. D minor. Okay, so you're going to come in here.
Okay.
Right where that hits is the verse.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. Coming in.
Verse first, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Papa aspirin if you're nauseous. Alzheimer's, you nostalgic. I prescribe you a pistol if you live outside of Boston. Hellrail told me if I wasn't feeling too well that I can eat a clip Newport and maybe some kale. I'll take a whiskey bath if I start getting itchy after running. You know I'm coming through gunning. NLE Chopper said, lick a penny for the cure. If my immune system's sick, then this'll make it pure. Erectile dysfunction? All you need to stop doing is drinking at luncheons, and that won't bring you your ruin. Stop touching motherfuckers with your hands. You're off a banana, and then you just throw in a couple Zans. That'll cure your
there
cough.
It is. There it is.
Okay, got it.
That'll cure your cough. I'll cut it right there. It's
like
the bad
it,
medical advice freestyle on tonight's
Ooh.
Sudden death.
Wee.
We're going.
One taking it. Let's go, man.
Okay, this was D minor auto-tune. Let me get that going here. D minor.
The kale bars. Wow, we got 8 minutes on the clock.
Make sure
sure this is on time and we are good to keep going here.
Yeah, we're feeling good about it. Aspirin if you're nauseous, all time is you nostalgic. I prescribe you a pistol if you live outside of Boston. Harold told me if I wasn't feeling too well that I can eat a clip Newport and maybe some Kale. I take a whiskey bath if I start getting itchy after running. You know I'm coming through gunning NLE.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yep,
sounds
yep,
good.
Yep.
All right, that's good.
That's good. Time for the hook.
Let's go into the hook. Here we go. Coming in right now.
Stop touching motherfuckers with your hands. You're off a banana, and then you just throw in a couple Zans. That'll cure your cough.
Okay, there's the hook right there.
Hold on. Let me get 1 second. I gotta figure out how I said this hook because I haven't said it in a while.
I got you. I got you. We got 7 minutes left, chat.
Okay, got it, got it. Let's get it.
Here we go. Coming in.
Stop touching motherfuckers with your hands. You're off a banana, and then you just throw in a couple Zans.
If
that'll
you woke
cure
up
your
with
cough.
A headache, then I bet you I could heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see, I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD.
Oh, yes. You spread misinformation with the PhD?
That's it. That's it right there.
Nice federal
crime. I'm feeling
good
about that.
You're on the Mystery School stream tonight. Nice. That was a smooth hook.
Here for Banex smoothie, said moving wife. Yeah, Papa Banana Xanax, man.
Yeah, the Banex. Let me just duplicate this guy so we can.
Hopefully we can go through and get a double today.
Oh,
maybe
yeah,
we'll finish
got time.
In time.
We got time. I think
6 minutes on the clock, y'all. This is sudden death. If you're just now tuning in, we're making this song live from scratch in under 30 minutes. That clock out there is real.
Here we go.
You woke up with a headache, then I bet you I can heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see, I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD.
Yeah.
You woke up with
cool. You want to do doubles of this? We can record doubles.
Yeah, let's do that now, and then we'll do the second verse.
Okay, here we go. Coming in right beforehand.
For banana, and then you just throw in a couple Zans. That'll cure your cough.
If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I could heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see, I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD. Woke up with a headache, then I bet you I could heal ya. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see, I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD.
Dude, misinformation with the PhD line with beat drop, that actually sounds kind of nice.
Let's go. I think we got one on our hands tonight,
man. Let me just turn this guy up here.
Dad Tay, thank you for that sub, too.
Dad Tay, appreciate you, man. Welcome to all the new viewers. We made this whole song live in 30 minutes. You chose the topic, but we're not done yet. We got to do the second verse.
We're not done. Don't pop your bananas in yet.
Banax.
Your Banax. Right. Don't do that yet. The Zanana.
All right, here we go. Coming in from halfway through the hook into the second verse.
Okay. You woke up with a headache, then I bet you I can heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see, I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD. So you can freebase your back shot. I tried it, then I tapped out. Just make sure you drink your goat milk before the back shots. And gas station dick pills, they make you feel well. And they make sure that your shit heals if it's not doing well. Took some blood thinners off of Instagram. They made me blind, and then I just grew a hand. And I'm so healthy. I'm on that damn, messed it up.
Oh, no, that sounded great. You're going in. You're going good. Where do you want to punch from?
Let me see. We got 4 minutes. Let me hear it real quick, and then
you can freebase your back shot. I tried it, then I tapped out. Just make sure you drink your goat milk before the back shots. And gas station dick pills, they make you feel well. And they make sure that your shit heals if it's not doing well. Took some blood thinners off of Instagram. They made me blind, and then I just grew a head.
Right there, right there. Cut it right there. Yeah.
You also said, I'm off that good. I'm off that, damn. Which sounded kind of nice, actually. All right, here we go. Coming in shortly beforehand. Here we go.
Some blood thinners off Instagram. They made me blind, and then I just grew a hand. I'm on that gunner, and
Dr. Umar diet. Only whippets and white women, I swear you gotta try it. That kombucha tastes great when it's going down your throat. Just make sure you chase it with a little oil from a boat. I guess that makes your throat slippery, but you won't be sick and never get rid of me. Peace.
Oh! Yes!
I don't know what was said. It's fine. Don't know how it turned out. It
turned out great, dude. I'm telling you. This is the medical misinformation freestyle is going in right now, dude.
The magic of sudden death.
We are about to get these bars banned off of Facebook for how much truth they have and how many dark secrets about the medical industry they
oil
bring
from
to
a boat.
Good cod liver oil. Yeah, yes, dude, that's what we're talking about. All right, we have just enough time for an ad lib track if you want to.
Yeah, yeah, lace me up, man. I wanna get this one sonically robust tonight, man.
All right. Ad lib track coming in from the beginning of the song right here. Here we go.
Ah, yes. You look a little pale. Have you ingested some peanut M&Ms today? I think those'll do the trick.
Yeah. Papa aspirin if you're nauseous. Alzheimer's, you nostalgic. I prescribe you a pistol if you live outside of Boston. Hellrail told me if I wasn't feeling too well, that I can eat a clip Newport and maybe some Kale. I take a whiskey bath if I start getting itchy after running. You know I'm coming through gunning. NLE Chopper said lick a penny for the cure. If my immune system's sick, then this'll make it pure. Erectile dysfunction? All you need to stop doing is drinking at luncheons, and that won't bring you your ruin. Stop touching motherfuckers with your hands. You're off a banana, and then you just throw in a couple Zans. That'll
cure
your
cough. If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I can heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see? I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD. If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I can heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see? I want you better than me.
Better
I spread
than me.
A little misinformation with my PhD.
So you can freebase your back shot. I tried it and I tapped out. Just make sure you drink your goat milk before the back shots. And gas station dick pills, they make you feel well. And they make sure that your shit heals if it's not doing well.
Okay.
Took some blood thinners off of Instagram. It made me blind and then I just grew a hand. I'm on that gunner. Dr. Umar diet, only whippets and white women, I swear you gotta try it. That kombucha tastes great when it's going down your throat. Just make sure you chase it with a little oil from a boat. I guess that makes your throat slippery. But you won't be sick and never get rid of me. If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I can heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror, you see? I want you better than me.
Better
I spread
me.
A little misinformation with my PhD. If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I can heal ya. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror, you see? I want you better than me.
The outro.
I spread a little misinformation with my PhD.
I don't know if he's gonna make it, nurse. Maybe we should let's take him outside, give him 30 cc's of the Black Rhino dick pill, and hopefully that'll resuscitate his heart.
Yes! Another one.
The boys have done it again. Another sudden death under our belt with 0.3 seconds left on the clock. They beat the clock and they beat the medical system tonight,
guys. Yes, Chad, we got the medical advice that the establishment does not want you to hear on the Mystery School stream tonight. If you tuned in late or you're watching from the front page, hey, front page viewers, click into the stream. It's worth it. I promise. Just give it a little click. Just come on in. Hit us with a follow.
Touch it. Sniff on it. I promise you, you'll like it. Anyway, just come on, man.
If you're watching from the front page, you're new to the stream. This segment was called Sudden Death. We made that entire song live in under 30 minutes. And you chose tonight's topic based off of the news that we covered on the stream. And unfortunately, the article that spawned tonight's topic was this one.
NLE Choppa, famous rapper giving out crazy medical advice to all.
Yeah.
Man, poop 5 to 7 times a day or you're sick as shit, says NLE Choppa.
So NLE Choppa is giving out some questionable medical advice, and our chat voted, of course, for the
questionable medical advice freestyle tonight. And, oh, dude, we're still in the crime dimension.
We need to get out of here because it hurts. Every second that we're here, it makes my blood hurt a little bit.
Computer?
Yo.
Take us home.
I thought you'd
please
never ask.
Ow.
All right,
we made it back. And frankly, I'm glad that we made it back out of there, man. Yeah. This has been a action-packed evening. There was medical advice being thrown out. There were small mayo doors that we ran mm-hmm. into. Who knows what else is in store for us tonight, man?
Yeah, who knows? Unfortunately, nothing, because this is where the stream ends. But we are going to thank tonight's gifters, play the song one more time, and then we're going to find someone in the music section with either zero or one viewer to raid. So if you're watching from the front page right now, you enjoyed what you saw, consider clicking into the stream. We're all about spreading the love after the stream. It's hard to stream on Twitch. It's even harder to do music content on Twitch. So if you're enjoying what you saw, consider clicking in, dropping a follow, and accompany us to this raid of someone who has one or zero viewers. Also, Sam Strain, thanks for the compliments, man. We saw you as a first-time viewer saying
thanks,
nice
Sam.
Things. Thank you very much. So,
Biker Mouse TV. Thank you for those small dancing mice emotes nice. in the comments there. Nice. Love those. And we appreciate all of our new all of our new followers. Make sure you just hit a follow up for us, or hop in our Discord and follow us on there too, so we can alert you when this happens more often.
Yes.
Man, we would love for you to come back and enjoy some more of the Mystery School.
Easy Mac 95. Thanks for that prime sub. And Markov, thank you for the gifted sub, man.
Thank you, Markov.
Welcome
appreciate
to
that.
All of the front page viewers. If you're tuning in for the first time, you don't know what it is that you're watching the Mystery School stream, the first interactive late night show on the internet where the hosts are also the musical guests. A depraved, despicable concept, but someone's got to do it, and those someones are us.
Somebody's got to do it, man. It hurts, but I mean, we're used to it by now.
Yeah,
so
you know, it's fine. It's all good. So we are live Monday, Wednesday, Friday nights, 9 p.m. Central to midnight, right here on the Mystery School stream. Zions, thank you for that gifted sub. Samuel on the beat, thank you for the W as the first message.
Go,
man. Thank
big
you.
W's, man.
Oh, we appreciate that.
You guys, make sure you join our Discord, man. We'd love to have you there. It's sticky in there in the Discord, but just don't touch the walls or touch the doorknobs or anything like that. Mm-hmm. You'll be all right, man.
Yeah.
And that gun on the table, you can fondle it and play with it and let a round off if you want to, and nobody's going to tell. Nobody even cares, man.
That's
it's
true.
It's the Mystery School Discord. Anything goes.
It's
in
true.
There, so.
And speaking of the Discord, every single news article that we cover on the stream comes from the stream news section. So if you see something online that you want us to cover on the show, maybe even make a song about live in under 30 minutes, just weasel your way on into the stream news section and drop the link in there. It doesn't have to be an article. It can be a tweet, an image, something cool going on in the world that you think us
right.
or our viewers would appreciate. So just hop on in there and, let it rip, as they say. So
that's right.
Dude, you know, it was a great stream today. It was the start of the week. Can we get another round of
Mystery School Union emotes in the chat, please?
Put them up, man.
Please.
It's a goddamn Monday, man, and we loved having you guys come into our house with your shoes on tonight and you scuffed all
yes.
over the walls and the carpet's all sticky, but you got to see us make a song and you hung out with us, and some of you even gave me some good lines to rap tonight, man. So you're talented, you're cute, you smell like Nag
nice.
Champa sometimes,
oh, wow.
too, which ain't bad.
Nice.
You know?
Yeah, that's a delectable smell, honestly. You can hit the glong, too, says Mercenary Gary. All right, so we're going to thank tonight's gifters really quick and find someone to raid. We get that it's late. If you got to go to bed, we totally understand. But if you can hang out with us for another couple minutes or so, let's make someone's night, man. We've had great luck of finding people in the music section with zero or one viewers who are really cool and talented musicians. So help us make their night or their
That's
day
right.
or whatever the hell. We'd appreciate it very much. So, tonight's gifters, thank you very much to Zeens with a gifted sub, Markov with one, Easy Mac with a new sub, Markov with two, actually, Lame
Markov
Jane with 500 bits, Plantscape with 300 bits, Markov with three gifted subs, Tick the West with one, The Nash Attack with two, Dr. Eam with one, Real Gamer with five gifted subs, and Anthony with 100 bits. Thank you.
Wow.
Appreciate
what
that.
A great night, man. Thank you to all our cool gifters gifting us sexy gifts and gifting all over the place like that, man. It's Monday, so that means the next time you'll see us is Wednesday, which unfortunately is a whole day away,
yeah.
man. But in the meantime, join our Discord and hang out in there. we come in there sometimes to curse and to
and spit and hiss.
Ask for fraud, ask for certain personal information that you have. So join our Discord. It's right here in the header here. You like the letters that we arranged there. Go in there, have a good time, and we'll see you guys on Wednesday.
Yes, indeed we will. So let's find someone to raid here. Hop in the Discord, and we will play the track once again for the outro before we do the raid, so don't worry, we're playing that back. Murphy says, even social security numbers? CCV codes of credit cards, full names.
Mother's maiden name, father's maiden name.
Recovery passwords, you know.
First pet you
exactly,
had.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. First elementary school teacher that you liked. We need all that information because it helps us to develop a better stream.
Yes.
Not to fraud your personal information and rob you financially. That's not what we're doing.
No way. Absolutely.
That would be crazy, man. So just come on into the Discord, man.
Skill Eagle says 9 days until the 420 stream as well. Yes, we do have a special 420 stream prepared Wednesday after this coming one, so you're going to want to be here for that. But in the meantime, let's find someone to raid here. This person says imbued with the powerful power of shit.
Oh, is that an NLE Chopper stream?
Yes, 5 to 7 times a day. Earth Modular Society, what's going on here? What's this? I want some... Oh, it's actually exactly what I thought it was, which is bleeping and blooping modular sense.
A lot of good bleep bloops. Well, if that's going for 24 hours, I'll tune into that later after my fever dream so I can get a little dysphoric for 10 minutes.
Yeah, I need a dysphoria stream to tune into. Let's see. We're going to find someone who needs the raid tonight, man.
Somebody needs it. It's Monday. It's April. This has been God, April's a crazy month, man. It's all taxes and, pay me and money and, wild month, man. So somebody's gonna need this raid right now.
Can we get a 1 in the chat if you've had uncomfortable time doing your taxes? 2 in the chat if you're an advocate for tax fraud.
Won't say that here publicly, but I am sort of an advocate for it. Not publicly on Twitch, though.
Let's see what's going on here. Oh, 2. We got advocates for tax fraud in the chat right now.
Well, they're just nameless names in the chat, so nobody can catch them. Is this person live?
Yeah.
Voice sounding nice.
Indubitably, Brian is a contender for tonight's raid, man. I think we should keep looking for a second here. And if we don't find someone right away, I think Indubitably Brendan is getting the raid.
No, I like the voice right there.
We just raid off of the vibes, man. What about Lemonade Alley?
That's all we do is vibe here.
What's Lemonade Alley going on here?
And that one, by the way, Jesus. That one, that's a weird one, because it's supposed to be...
What kind of song are we playing here?
Fuck. Let's see.
I thought it was like this, but it looks like it's fucking this.
Hey, we're on the front page, ma'am.
That's too hard to do.
We'll check back in on Lemonade Alley here.
Yeah, I think she's getting warmed up.
She's getting warmed up here. All right, let's just scroll for a second longer, and then we'll find who has the raid tonight. Anyone playing an instrument here? There's Scorpion Entertainment.
It looks like a strip club in Grand Theft Auto right there.
All right. Someone here deserves the raid, man. Who's it going to be? Should we just do Indubitably Brendan?
Who's that in that pink room?
What's going DJ on right guy. There? Dance Hardstyle.
Yep, that'll get us DMCA'd.
Yep.
It looks like Indubitably Brendan is still the... highest contender
okay,
here.
Okay, yeah, I think we're gonna hit Indubitably Brendan with the raid tonight, man. I always get excited when I see the accordion guy, and it's always a restream, man.
It ain't what you think it is. Yeah, don't hype yourself up. That guy's not there.
All right, everyone. We are going to raid a nice looking gentleman that we just stumbled across named Indubitably Brendan in the music section. We do this at the end of each one of our streams, or most of our streams, to spread some love, man. So if you got nothing nice to say, don't say anything at all. If you're on board to raid a music streamer with 1 viewer and show some love, please stick around.
Show this person some love. It's fun. It's a cool raid. And from what I heard, this person has a really cool voice and is playing the guitar really well. So might be some good music. Maybe they take requests. You never know. But make sure you go in and show some love and be respectful. And with that being said, I guess we'll get ready to leave you guys off to the raid and play that song one more time before we get out of here.
All right. So that's it from us at the Mystery School headquarters. We are live once again Monday, Wednesday, Friday nights, 9 p.m. Central, right here on the Mystery School channel. Join the Mystery School Discord if you got news for us to post or you want to just hang out with some cool-ass people. Discord in the chat or hit this link. We're going to be in there after the stream. And if you want to re-watch full episodes of the stream, we got a link to our VODs YouTube channel right below. And you can watch them all for free, man. We upload each one immediately after the stream goes offline. So that's where you can find
those. You pay with a little bit of your soul, but...
Just a little bit.
It's not money, though, so...
Just a little bit. It's fine.
Pay with just a little soul, but...
All right.
Otherwise, it's free.
Let's get the hell out of here and play this song one more time before we start the raid. Thank you very much to all of our new front page viewers who decided to stick around and follow. Of course, all of our dear regular viewers. Not regular in the normal sense. Regular in the we love you sense. Thanks for watching the stream.
Regular in the sense of you'd be a guy just standing in line at the DMV and I'd see him and be like, oh, yeah,
regular guy there.
Exactly, man. But we love you nonetheless. And I think that it's time to play that track before we leave you guys off to our raid.
It is.
And we'll see you Wednesday night.
All right, everyone. Have a great rest of your night. Have a great day tomorrow. Stay safe. Stay healthy. We'll see you on Wednesday and in the Discord. Stick around for the raid. Peace out. We love you.
Ah, yes, you look a little pale. Have you ingested some peanut M&Ms today? I think those are
Yeah.
Pop a aspirin if you're nauseous. All time is you nostalgic. I prescribe you a pistol if you live outside of Boston. Harold told me if I wasn't feeling too well that I can eat a clip Newport and maybe some Kill. I take a whiskey bath if I start getting itchy after running. You know I'm coming through gunning. NLE chopper said lick a penny for the cure. If my immune system's sick, then this'll make it pure. Erectile dysfunction? All you need to stop doing is drinking at luncheons, and that won't bring you your ruin. Stop touching motherfuckers with your hands. You're off a banana, and then you just throw in a couple Zans. That'll cure your cough.
If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I could heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see, I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD. If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I could heal you. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror. You see, I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD.
So you can freebase your back shot. I tried it and I tapped out. Just make sure you drink your goat milk before the back shots. And gas station dick pills, they make you feel well. And they make sure that your shit heals if it's not doing well. Took some blood thinners off of Instagram. They made me blind and then I just grew a hand. I'm on that gunna. Dr. Umar diet, only whippets and white women, I swear you gotta try it. That kombucha tastes great when it's going down your throat. Just make sure you chase it with a little oil from a boat. I guess that makes your throat slippery, but you won't be sick and never get rid of me. P. You woke up with a headache, then I bet you I can heal ya. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror, you see. I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD. If you woke up with a headache, then I bet you I could heal ya. Take a look inside my eyes and look inside the mirror, you see. I want you better than me. I spread a little misinformation with my PhD.
All right, everyone, have a great rest of your night, and please stick around for the raid if you don't mind.
Oh, yes. Show our new friends some love. Be respectful and cool. And, we'll catch you guys on Wednesday. Same time, same place, 9 p.m. Central. We love you.
Same time, same place. We'll see you then. Have a great night. Have a great day tomorrow. Sleep tight. Enjoy this kiss on the forehead. Mwah.
A little wet one there, but you liked it. It's okay.
All right. We'll see you on Wednesday. Peace.
Peace.